Welcome to our live stream. We are doing a $300 gaming PC. Really, we're doing Athlon 3000G build, which technically can do gaming. And I thought, actually, given our discussion on Full Nerd yesterday, would be interesting to see how it does with GeForce Now. I have been tearing down one of our old systems, our Xbox One X build, because this is the only A320 board that we have. So we're running a little late, sorry about that. You get to watch me finish cleaning off the cooler here, which I'll note, the chip we have in here is a Ryzen 3 1200, and so the cooler that it comes with is the one I'm gonna be using, which is not actually the cooler that the Athlon 3000G comes with, but as you can see, I had to ask AMD for one because at the time I asked, there was just none available retail. So this does not come with the cooler. I'm using a slightly better cooler, in essence. If you get a retail version, it does have a cooler. I think that one's only rated for 65 watts. So it's a little bit lighter weight, but it'll handle that particular processor just fine.
Very interesting.
Hi.
Very interesting. I like
it. A wild Adam appears.
Yeah, I need to preface everybody. Thanks for holding on. Of course, there's always technical difficulties to be had every damn time.
It wasn't just me holding things up, thankfully.
I struggled for half an hour with these stupid HDMI adapters that I have attached to these cameras, not realizing that they bust all the time. So that was fun. Also, I didn't have time to set up one of my normal laptops for the remote streaming thing, so please forgive me. I have a MacBook.
Hey.
Yes.
It's a valid life choice. That's what Gordon would say if he was in the right mood for it.
Yeah. So I'm actually I'm going to be sitting at the table here with Elena, and controlling the switcher remotely, which is a nice feature. Hopefully the audio is coming in nice and clear. We got some music still going in the background. And I have the overhead cam set up for whenever we want to start. You know what? Actually, it probably helps if I would bring up chat.
Fun fact, apparently, I mean, I haven't run the Xbox One X build in a while, at least a year. But the thermal paste, the pre-applied thermal pad on this cooler, when you remove it, it comes apart in like little, it leaves behind like these little strips. So I don't know if you saw me earlier gently trying to tap some of it off because there's little bits of debris everywhere, and there's actually some in the fins right here. So I'm just trying to clean this up a little bit before I reuse it.
Tap, tap, tap-a-roo.
Tap, tap, tap.
Just so if you want to scoot over too, this is kind of the...
The center?
Yeah.
The heart of everything? I'll do that when I actually start building.
Yeah, no worries. I'm just bringing up the chat. Sorry, I don't have that set up. Life control
and if anyone's wondering why I didn't do this earlier, what I was doing on the system before was prepping all the drives that I was thinking of using. So that way, when we jump to whatever benchmarks we decide to do and the GeForce Now testing, we don't have to wait for all that installation. So I was occupied. I wasn't just sitting around eating breakfast on Instagram. Not that I actually am ever on Instagram.
In front of the show, Dennis said to turn down the music a little bit. Turned it down 4 decibels. Let me know how that is, my friend.
4 decibels. You can get that precise?
Oh, I can get precise. It goes down to 0.0 decibels.
Where did I put? Oh, there it goes. All right, I'm pretty much done with tearing down, except one little thing here. I have to actually remove that M.2 drive, just so that people will say that I actually built this from the ground up.
It did not come pre-installed like that.
Nope.
It did not come pre-installed like that. Cool. Audio sounds good. We got all the cool people here. We also, this is a world's first for PC World. This is our first build streamed in 4K. So hopefully you're going to be able to see all of the components in crystal clear 4K vision.
Yep.
And it looks like
every single flaw on my face.
At least according to the YouTube analytics, not many people are using the 4K setting. No, actually it's topping out at 1440p. I forgot, I changed it to
You did change it,
well,
right?
Especially for the build, Because we definitely want more real-time interaction. For those of you who joined us yesterday for the Full Nerd, a little bit of inside baseball, I changed some of the settings on YouTube to be able to give the 4K video option during the live show. The problem is that it creates more of a delay between us streaming it out and seeing the chat.
Oh my gosh.
So I wanted to,
everywhere.
Especially for the build, kind of tune that back the other way to say, hey, for the live build itself, it tops out at 1440p, but we get to see the chat sooner. But the 4K option is still available on demand after the fact. So.
All right.
So yeah, let's, if you want to scoot over a little bit, we can start.
Yeah, I can actually start.
I can switch over to the overhead cam.
All right, so.
Hopefully it's in focus.
The parts that we're using, like actually I should get my laptop up so I can read out loud what we're doing here. It's in the description of the video, I believe, but I do want to note that we have some substitutions just because of availability in our lab. It's really close though, and honestly for this build, I know some people really like it when you build exactly what you list there, but for me this is more about just a general budget build. It's not specifically like this is the exact build that everyone should do.
Makes sense to me.
With that in mind, I will read out what we have. So we're going to be building with the Athlon 3000G, which is the star of the show. This is really the part that I want to test out and see how it does. This is a two-core, four-thread part. It is $50 MSRP, and it has integrated graphics. So technically, this can be used to game on.
Wow.
And we're going to try it. From all the reports, it's not going to be great, but
how's the Athlon version different than the normal?
What do you mean?
Or is it always the Athlon when we talk about like the best video card of what last year? Was that an Athlon? Was that technically
no, Athlon? No, that was a Ryzen APU.
Oh, okay.
So this one is based on Raven Ridge as well. But this one is being branded as an Athlon processor, and this is I believe original Zen micro architecture.
Oh, so it's just the older
But I
older
think,
architecture, but it's still that same 3000G.
Well, they put, I think they put the naming here so that it seems like it's part of the current generation.
That's why I was confused.
But it is very confusing because the microarchitecture being used is not actually Zen 2.
Got it.
It's older. This is a 14 nanometer part.
people are angry that I'm using a MacBook, so I'm going to find a sticker somewhere quick.
I don't think
As
I
you
can
talk about the parts list, I'll...
Here, do you want to put my Gudetama thing right in front of your Apple thing? Like, well, can you hook it over?
Oh, I don't think so. I'll find a sticker. Give me a second. You talk about the parts.
Yeah, okay. So the motherboard I have here is an ASRock A320M HDV Micro ATX board. It's just, you know, that's... So one thing that I realized when I was looking at prices, this board right now retails for $55. During Black Friday, you could get a B450 board on sale for about that price. So whenever anyone tells me that you can't get a good deal during Black Friday, I always laugh a little bit. Just a little bit.
All right, handy dandy gaff tape. Makes sense.
Oh, you're gonna actually tape it over? You gonna do any patterns with it?
No.
All right.
I'm not getting fancy.
So for memory, I have DDR4 3000 megahertz. This package got a little dented in transit, so if this set doesn't work, I have another pack behind me that I'll use instead. But I think the RAM sticks are actually okay, but we'll see. If it doesn't post, this will be the first thing that I try to troubleshoot.
All right.
So I don't know if you can see this, but it dented.
Whoops.
Not just a little bit, but a lot. In the parts list, I actually recommended a set of Patriot, like a pack of, also a pack of two. This one, let's see, this one actually is a set of 16, so I can't do dual channel on this. I actually might step down to 2800 because I have a match set for that, now that I think about it.
Dad isn't mad, no. I use Android, I'm an Android person. This is the Samsung Galaxy S10, no, the Note 10 Plus. Newest one, so no, I am not an Apple person.
I believe both of them are, I believe both the packs I have are 16 gig sets, so if I were gonna use 8. I mean, I could drop in 16, but that changes the price of the build. So I think I'll just use the 2800 speed.
All right, sounds good.
I recommended Patriot in the list. That's only because it was the cheapest set for a dim set, four gigs each.
Dennis asks, did you upgrade the BIOS or there is no need for Athlon?
I did upgrade the BIOS on this board, which is also why I spent a lot of time doing prep beforehand. This board actually came with the original version, which I think was like 2.30. I had to step it up to 5.9, and I had to do it in two steps, and also upgrade the display drivers each time as well. So it took a little bit.
Bronco Monk asks, or says they cleared 4 hours of their time to watch this build. Do you think you can do it in 4 hours?
I would like to do it in two, but I don't want to jinx anything.
We're already way behind schedule.
Well, hopefully this build is quick. To finish answering the question, though, I had considered seeing if I could just run it without updating the BIOS, but I decided not to risk it. I don't know. So as a result, I don't know if you would need to get a boot kit from AMD if you were trying to do the same build. But this board I bought in 2017. So if you buy the one I have in the link here is the A320M HDV R4. So I'm assuming that's revision 4. So hopefully the BIOS on that is, you know, more up to date. But if you're interested, I would actually contact like ASRock or Gigabyte or whoever the board maker is and ask them if whatever pre-installed version of the BIOS is would support this.
Before you install, is there anything you don't want seen on your screen? Because I'm going to switch to the overhead cam.
Nope, it's just the parts list.
All right. Then I am switching it over. Boom, to the overhead cam.
Yep. Storage. Okay, so storage is an interesting story here because this build is the first time in my entire life where I've realized just how little I think about PCIe lanes, because my whole life you just buy a Core i5, buy a Ryzen 3600, you've got plenty. You don't have to think, worry about, like, if you're doing a basic build, you have enough for your boot drive, you have enough for your GPU, you just drop everything, you're good to go. Well, the Athlon 3000G, and I haven't been able to confirm this, and I wish I had confirmed this with AMD beforehand, so that's my bad. I can't tell if this only has 6 PCIe lanes or 8, but it's not many. In fact, this 1200 has more. So as a result, I think I'm good to go with the storage. I don't think there's going to be too much of a conflict between storage and then later on, if we have time, if me adding in a discrete graphics card as well. But it'll be interesting to see how it all plays out. But for now, I'm going to be using an Intel 660p 512 gigabyte SSD. It seems a little expensive, and my justification for that is if you get a 1 terabyte hard disk drive, it's about $45. I think that paying a little bit more is worth it for how much faster your experience is going to be. And 512 is kind of a good spot where it'll be fast drive and you'll also have enough room for at least, you know, a good amount of games, whatever. And you can always add in a hard disk drive later on if you have lots of photos or whatever to store. All right. I like to do it so I can see the pins. Which I'm not doing a good job with right now. I can't see anything. Okay. Case, I was actually going to leave it to viewer's choice. So I have a Thermaltake Versa H15 on hand, and I also have a Thermaltake H22 on hand. And Thermaltake actually told me that the H22 is the more popular one, and I can see why. It has more drive cages, and it can accommodate more optical drives as well. But they're the same price right now on, I think it's Newegg or Amazon. So I'll let you all decide which one you prefer that I use.
VC Jester also says, who needs extra storage if you're using GeForce Now?
Which is something we're going to test.
Yeah.
And then finally, the power supply I recommended is a 450 watt, which, you know, according to calculators, should be more than enough if you decide to add something like the RX 570. I thought I had a 450 at home. The bare minimum I need is 435. I think I should be okay to run this with the 570, but for safety, I might just grab one of our 550s in that build right there that I've been mining. So again, it's not gonna line up exactly with what I have in the suggested part list, but again, this is more about general parts, not specific. This is the exact build that I think you should build.
Dad Isn't Mad is asking about the buzzing noise. That's your watch.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah.
It's picking up.
Oh yeah, it's loud.
Yeah, this is the Fitbit Inspire HR, and I swear this is the noisiest.
It's pretty loud.
This is the noisiest fitness tracker I've had when it comes to vibration. It's really strong, so I don't miss notifications. But sometimes when I'm sleeping and I am about to fall asleep, someone will message me, and this is a stripped down fitness tracker, so you don't have anything like with the Charge 3 where you can have it do not disturb hours. So it just buzzes, even though my phone is in D&D mode. And so I'll be half asleep and it goes, I'm like, oh, stop messaging me, people, go to bed.
Yeah,
it's noisy. So sorry about that. There you go again. All right, I think that's everything. It is a very simple build, so let's just get this cooler on. So normally when we do these builds, I weasel out of this, and I usually have Gordon do it, because I hate installing CPU coolers. There's a lot of strong language used whenever I have to do this, so you get to all watch this now in real time.
Well, luckily, the basic one's pretty chill compared
to
like
the first gen
of the Hyper 212 Evo.
I still hate putting on coolers. It's a very stressful experience for me.
I'll tell you what, I helped somebody over the Christmas break build their first PC, and I recommended the Hyper 212 Evo, and man, I always forget just how annoying that damn cross thing is. So when we saw the new upgraded V2 at CES, I was like, oh wow. Yeah, it was fresh on my mind how annoying that is. So the new version, nice.
I'll be excited to try it.
It's kind of like this, where it's got the plate that you kind of pre-install and then you attach the cooler to, rather than having to do both at the same time.
I'm looking at my pea-sized droplet here. It's a little large, but as we've all seen from Steve's video, there's actually a much wider allowance for how much too much thermal paste there is.
Mm-hmm. And somebody's asking if it's going to get close to the RAM slots. Do you know? Have you figured out the?
I mean, it probably will. I think I'm going to flip it this way so that this is not sticking right into the RAM. So I'll have a little extra clearance, but it should be fine. I can install the RAM sticks now. I actually pulled out the RAM sticks before I tore down this part, so I didn't have any problems removing them.
And yes, Dennis, I'm sorry, I think it was Dennis. This is a build, so we are taking food-related questions.
Do we do that? I don't remember.
You know
is
what?
That our thing?
I'm gonna call it now an official thing.
Oh, so are we talking about the things we like to eat or the things we want to eat because we're hungry?
Typically on A Full Nerd, we don't talk about food, but you know what, builds? Let's talk about food.
All
I'm
right.
down for it.
We've talked about favorite pizza toppings, I think, right?
I think we've talked about a lot of food stuff. Because I know there's the Subway and...
Yeah, I think I'll do it this way, just to make sure I have a little extra clearance.
Yeah.
All right, everybody, here we go.
You got it.
I hate this moment. Can't we just turn off the camera while I do this so I can swear to my heart's content? Oh, I hate this so much. Does anyone ever have this thing where when you know people are watching you, your brain automatically decides that's the time to mess everything up? But when no one's watching you, you're perfectly competent? That's me. Can't tell you how many times where I've been dancing. I actually compete sometimes, or I try to, and I've had a judge look at me, and suddenly I'm like, don't normally do that. Judge watching me.
They were literally judging you. Maybe that's
they
the
were
problem.
Literally judging me, and I decided to use that moment to tell them I was not worthy. Alas.
Also, let me know if the music's too loud or too quiet in those times of silent tension over on our side. Dennis,
dramatic.
Dennis is asking, what is your favorite sauce, except thermal paste, of course? I don't know what sauce.
I mean, is it
maybe
like
maybe just pizza?
Is it like or for chicken nuggets? Like, if we're talking McDonald's chicken nuggets,
hey, you know
I am
your
a sweet and sour kind of person.
Yeah, I'll also make chicken nuggets. So.
Hey, sometimes you gotta have a junk food fix.
Yeah, I'm more of a Taco Bell person myself.
What?
Oh,
you're giving me crap for chicken McNuggets and you go to Taco Bell?
McDonald's is like
you run
McDonald's
for the border, you also
like,
have to run for the bathroom afterwards.
McDonald's is like, in my opinion, like scraping the bottom of the barrel. It's
okay,
just like
I
the
need
most
you all to weigh in
because
this is ludicrous to me. This is ludicrous to me.
What? McDonald's has like no flavor, it's like cheap as hell and just
you're
a
willing
why it's so
to risk gastrointestinal distress?
I mean, I've never had that problem with Taco Bell. I go to the good Taco Bells.
Is there such a thing? I feel like you just said an oxymoron.
No, I like Taco Bell. Brad says, I don't like McDonald's much,
no
but their sauces are on point. Also, the for sauces in general, if I just had one, it would probably be an Alfredo sauce. Because it's good with pasta, and I actually like a white pizza from time to time. So, Alfredo sauce, I'll take it. But it's also like the thickest, most cholesterol-inducing sauce, probably. Maybe we got some love for Wendy's.
I like Wendy's.
Popeye's chicken sandwich. Ooh, you know what?
Popeye's.
I just had my first Popeye's chicken sandwich during Super Bowl. Yeah, I went over to...
specifically during the Super Bowl? Is like that a thing? Or are you just talking about first Popeyes?
No, yeah,
general?
My first Popeyes in general,
oh, okay.
Chicken sandwich specifically. I went over to our old video producer, Dan. Some of you might have remembered him. He left late last year to be a stay-at-home dad.
Take care of that baby.
His adorable baby. I'm not a big baby fan, but yeah. Dan's baby is awesome.
He produced
hilarious.
A good-looking kid.
He's great. Anyway, I went over to his house for Super Bowl. I hadn't seen him a bit. We weren't able to connect at CES. He actually went for a competing site. Jerk. Anyway, one of his friends came over and got 10 Popeye's chicken sandwiches, 5 spicy, 5 not. And,
okay, which one did you try?
I'm not a big spicy fan, so I just tried the normal one. And then I took one home. And ate it the next day, just heated up in the microwave. It actually was pretty good.
Popeye's is the best kind of fast chicken joint. Although Gordon says that there is a place somewhere, was it in the Mission or something, that has like, it's like gas station chicken that he says is supposed to be amazing.
I mean, there's also the guy who eats Subway for breakfast. So
he eats the least leftovers
eats,
at 2:30 p.m.
Yeah, he goes to the local Chinese deli. Right before they're gonna throw the stuff in the trash, he says, "Wait, no, hold on, I'll throw you a couple dollars before you throw."
They give him
the
a
trash.
Discount because he comes so late.
Yeah,
such a Chinese thing to do.
And because they know him probably at this point.
But yeah, it's an interesting place. It's like part deli, part what do you call those? The steaming tray things.
Yeah.
Like hot food stations. Hot food stations, essentially. And they have a mix
buffet.
It's kind of a buffet style, but it's actually got the chafing. That's not something like the chafing pans, whatever they're called. But it's a combination of like Chinese, Cantonese food, where like it's dim sum and chow mein and other very American type stuff. And then they have actual sandwiches, like American style sandwiches, and actual American style hot food as well. So I guess Gordon just likes going there because he has a bunch of variety. I think we're pretty much done. I just need to put this in the case and put in the power supply. Yes, fastest build ever.
Well,
I didn't jinx it.
We need to clean up the cabling. We need the audio card, right?
Okay.
Put the budget in
Do
the
we
audio
have
card
a vote? Now. Do we have a vote on the poll here? Like, which case should
Sorry,
I use?
Was there a vote?
Yeah. So, should I use...
Why don't you bring them up?
All right, here we go.
Just to show the
get some viewer
the voting
participation.
Options.
All right, so Thermaltake Versa H15.
How much is this?
Right now it's $45. I've seen it as cheap as $30 after rebate.
Okay. So that's option number one.
Option
the
number
Versa
one.
H15.
It's very, very basic. It's like got only one optical drive here. I think it's a little bit smaller than the H22, honestly, but I don't. I originally bought this for, wait, are we on the right camera?
Whoops.
Yeah, sorry.
Whoops-a-daisy, I am asleep at the
wheel.
Someone's
sleeping on the job. All right, okay, let's try this again. So this is the H15, or the Versa H15 from Thermaltake. It's got the one slot here for optical drive, but it's actually a little bit small. I originally got this case for the Xbox One X build, but the only RX 580 we had available at the time was this huge, massive, beefy GPU, and it didn't fit, which is why I had to build it in that old Enermax case that I had brought here from a previous job, because nobody else loves that case except for me. And I'm really only attached to it because I did my first build for work ever in that particular case. So I have a soft spot for it.
Wait, so it's between that and that?
No, it's between this and the H22, which I'll show in a second.
Oh, okay.
But I was just gonna say, I think this card, this 570, should fit in this particular case.
Is that one-to-one scale?
Well, I'm using the box as the reference.
All right, Versa, so that's option number one.
Versa H22. One of the reasons why I'm interested in building the H15 is because it has fewer drive cages, so it's a little bit cleaner. A little bit more spacious inside. This is the H22.
Option number two,
H22, it's got more optical bays, which isn't really applicable to this build anyway, but it's also, I believe, a little bit bigger than the H15, a little bit longer, so it accommodates bigger graphics cards.
We should also say the fact that you have a 570 goes above the $300.
Yes, it's an optional add-on. But we're gonna do if we have
time.
The
base build with, you know, GeForce Now is what we're doing here, but we have a 570 that we can plop
just
in.
To see how it goes, because that is going to get limited given how many PCI lanes are available on this build, so it'll be interesting to see what kind of performance you get out of it. And I should note that the reason I chose an RX 570 is because, honestly, in that price range right now, even though this is a much older card, you get a lot of performance for that price. This is going for about 110. No sales.
Man, it's pretty split, but it looks like the edge is for the H15.
All right, cool.
Yep. Nope.
Well,
okay.
If it still doesn't H15. Fit things, we're going to have to move into the H22 later anyway.
All right. H15. Yep. Nope. More votes are pouring in.
Cool. All right, let's do this.
And Peter Jansen, I play in both ecosystems. Even though I do most of my stuff on a PC, I'd like to have Mac laptops around to stay knowledgeable about the subject. And funny enough, this is actually the work-issued laptop I got when I first started here in 2015, back when the video department was all Mac. Our bosses were all Apple. And I had to show them the light of saying, hey, why don't we switch over to PC? So
you can build a system for far less than you would before.
Yeah. So thanks to me, our video team now runs all on PCs, but I still have this old work-issued laptop that I hold around. Also, I prefer to run Pro Tools when I do specific Pro Tools tasks on a Mac and a external...
I need to grab the motherboard shield from the other case. I'll be right back.
Technically, VC Jester, I'm not hired by PC World specifically. I'm hired by IDG. I work with PC World, Mac World, TechHive, Tech Advisor. I do stuff for our B2B channels. I do stuff for our marketing team. I do stuff for our SMS, which is a custom services team. So technically I'm an employee of IDG, not specifically PC World. Especially in those early days, I didn't get to just focus on the PC World stuff, but as time evolved, I said, hey, I like being a part of PC World. I want to be able to work on there almost exclusively. So yeah, even though I work with all the brands,
Sorry, I'm just going to interrupt real quick.
Go for it.
Anyone who's actually using this video as a guide for their first build, or they haven't built many, as you can see, I'm actually pulling out spare parts from this because this was all part of that Xbox One X build. One of the things I like to do is keep the motherboard box and just put any spare components related to or accessories related to my builds in here so I can find it again later.
Yeah, I find it the best box to hold all the other random little pieces.
Yep.
PSU box is usually a little too big.
A little bit too big.
Same with the GPU.
Yeah, and for the record, I'm actually not only tied to PC World myself. I have written stuff for both our PC World sister sites, TechHive and MacWorld.
And no, I'm not getting multiple checks. Like I said, I work for IDG. IDG pays my bills.
Yep.
And so, yeah.
That's... We work for one company that owns multiple brands.
Exactly, yeah.
It's kind of like the same as Condé Nast or what Hearst Publishing.
I mean, back in the day, things were very segmented out. Even Macworld and PC World had completely different HR departments, accounting.
Did they really?
Departments. I mean, yeah, everything was very segregated. But you know, as time goes on, you'd be like, okay, well, why do we have to have a PC World and a Macworld HR department? Why don't we? It didn't make any sense. So. And yes, I do love the salt that Gordon brings to my life every day. You have no idea the kind of chats that we have around the office.
So just to recap, so you all don't have to watch.
I'm showing the top down.
Okay. So you don't all have to watch the Xbox One X bill to find this. What happened was the card previously was so long it hit this. It wouldn't actually sit because it was hitting this lip here.
Yeah, now you got plenty of room.
I have plenty of room with this particular card. Just gonna see what's going on with the connectors here. My watch is definitely okay. That's case fan. All right. Oh hey, look at me! Look at past me, setting myself up for success here. Like I put the screws in the
For
the standoff,
yeah,
so wow, I have it all set to go.
Look at that!
Wow, good job, past me. Past me is not always so reliable.
Naga, I will say, even though we all actually work pretty well together and there's crossover, Blake Johnson from Macworld was on the Full Nerd yesterday. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Gordon has helped on Macworld videos back when the Core i9 problems were happening. But back in the day, and even though I wasn't there, I have heard, yes, PC Worlders and Macworlders wouldn't even go to lunch together. It was,
is that true? Are you just starting rumors
no,
about I, how it used
to be? No, that's not a
be?
Rumor. That's what I've heard is that it was pretty. I mean, I think it was all still in a loving way, but it.
They just had no time for each other.
true.
Macworld used to put on that expo, didn't they?
The Macworld Expo is where Steve Jobs revealed the iPhone and.
I'm not doing well in life.
A MacBook and all that fun stuff.
Come on. This is cosmetic. This doesn't have to happen, but I just don't want the... Since I'm not using optical drive, I'm trying to put this back in. I did it, everybody.
And yes, when I say in the good old days, back in the days of print. Print was... actually, this room, some of you might have heard me tell this story before. This room used to be the photo studio back in the day during the print magazine. Days they had I've heard at its peak up to 14 staff photographers.
That's incredible.
I mean, they had I still have it out here actually, this motorized turntable to be able to take 360-degree shots of 360-degree shots of parts. You think about a magazine.
There we go.
You need a lot of photography for a magazine, so yeah, they took a lot of
I will
a
say,
lot of photos.
I'm so okay. It's not purely that I'm lazy. I'm not a visual person. Anyone who's seen my stick figure drawings will confirm this for you. So I actually really miss the days of print where we had dedicated photographers and art directors and such because they would take care of all of that. You would just write your story and that's it, you were done. But now in today's online world, you have to do it all yourself pretty much.
Yeah,
it sucks.
I'm probably the closest to a staff photographer that we still have. I do have some people still ask me to take some photos for articles and stuff like that, but yeah, it's... In all respects, journalism, video, it's a lot of technical skills like this have been, you gotta be a one-man band, you gotta be able to do everything.
Yeah.
I mean, when I first got hired, I just got hired as a shooter editor. So, our producer would tell us exactly what we needed to shoot. We didn't really have too much input on what the shoot was, we just did it. And then after the video was edited, it got handed off and we had no idea where it went or what people liked about it. And it wasn't until later that I was able to get on the production side that I was like, wow, okay, I feel like I can make better videos because I have more an investment and understanding of not only the pre-production but also the post-production, the final upload, and you know, reading comments and all that fun stuff. So even though you know I have the technical, more of a technical background, it's actually fun to learn about the analytical stuff on the back end, because then that's how you learn to make better videos, by hearing all these beautiful comments from you fans out there.
I wish I had actually thought to bring two containers for screws so I could keep these separate, but I'm gonna have to run the risk of losing one and just leave them out wild and free. Not my preference, because I am a klutz. And I kick things and things go spilling out other places. Unfortunately, I'm not working on the floor today, which is what I tend to do at home, because I have a hardwood floor.
Peter Jansen says, Gordon is not present. The build is going a lot faster. Kind of true.
A little bit true.
I mean, we've run into problems. Every build has its problems.
I have definitely had my builds where I'm taking the leisurely route, folks.
Yeah. Well, especially if we get into like cable management and stuff like that.
Cable management is where it really goes slowly. I do think there was a period, because I had done it for the RGB build, that I got in this mode where I thought I had to do it for every build, and it was prolonging it. This one, not really a concern. I'm just gonna shove this in and see how it performed. That's really what I'm curious about.
Dennis asks a food-related question, if you're ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Is there something you can cook very well and proud about?
Not particularly. I don't think I cook poorly. I learned from my dad, who's a very good cook, so I think just by osmosis, I'm definitely competent, but I wouldn't say I have anything that I think is amazing. I honestly live kind of like a stereotypical mid-1900s century bachelor, where I mooch off of friends, I go out to eat, et cetera, et cetera.
I pride myself in making really good toast, double-decker peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, and this dessert that is a chocolate peanut butter pie that is essentially a big Reese's cup.
Oh, are we talking about baking?
Whatever, anything.
I like to bake more than I like to cook, to be honest.
Also, I think it was Peter who asked where Gordon is. Gordon is around. I actually honestly have no idea what he's up to right now.
He's working.
Well, maybe. I don't even know that. Who knows? He's at his desk. I'm surprised. I told him to
come over. He got stuff to do.
So yeah, I think he'll come in a little bit.
He was taking a meeting earlier.
Yeah. And then somebody else asked something. Crap. Oh yeah, nubs with guns. What's with all the metal tools? Not a good idea.
Pretty standard, actually.
Yeah.
I wouldn't recommend going around poking at things with them.
Oh, here we go. Ricardo asks, how much is the M.2 drive on the motherboard, and what size is it?
Let me finish answering the last one real quick.
Oh.
I was just going to say that one of the advantages of having the metal screwdriver is that if you work with magnetized screwdrivers, and I highly recommend that you do when you're PC building, is that you can essentially do this. You don't have to worry about screws dropping into your system.
Nice.
Second question was how much the 660p is.
And so this is what size?
This is 512 gigabyte capacity. And right now, or at least yesterday when I did all the pricing, it was going for $70. So it's a really $25 increase over if you wanted to go super bare bones and do just a 1 terabyte Western Digital Blue drive.
Also, but the part you listed in the description is a PNY CS900.
So I put different options in there. So I think I did a budget SSD, a 500 gigabyte SSD as the base option. But this particular motherboard supports NVMe drives. So I thought I'd give it a shot. Or I should at least say, yeah. I thought I'd give that a shot instead, because it's a cleaner build, honestly, and I kind of like that.
Also, I think it was friend of the show, Ruru2, was asking if if there's an overclock option on this motherboard. Oh, yeah, it was Ruru2.
Let me get my head out of the way. I believe there is. I didn't really look at it. I know the 3000G is unlocked, so you can overclock it. That wasn't really my focus for this build. My focus was more about budget, as low as possible. When I have a moment when I'm not building, I'll look at the manual and just verify whether or not it supports it.
Also, one great thing about
it's an A320 board, which is not really suited for overclocking anyway.
One good thing about this board is that there's only two DIMM slots, so we don't have to repopulate which ones. It's just, if you got
also,
dual channel, there you go.
If you watched our other live builds, you know that tends to be our downfall. It's either the placement of the DIMMs or if I'm involved with plugging in power cables.
Yeah, we will make sure everything in this gets powered.
Seated properly. Someone on Discord actually did give me a little bit of crap about that yesterday, and I was like, well, sorry, joke's on you this time because I have a non-modular power supply that I'm using.
Oh, that's how you kept the price down.
Nice. Modular power, even semi-modular power supplies are pretty expensive right now. I mean, all the tariff stuff, cases and power supplies are still kind of pricey. Before you could get 450-watt Corsair power supplies for like $20 after mail-in rebate, and I haven't seen that in a long time. Can I use your knife, please? May I use your knife, please? Thanks.
Sorry about that. Unfortunately, these new mic packs don't have an easy mute switch. Oh, no, there it is.
Oh, you got new packs? Cool.
Yeah, some people had asked, or I think I showed this off before CES. We switched over to the AVX system.
Oh, that's right.
Which is nice. This is actually the first time I'm using them for a live build. I usually use my old ones. Hopefully, there's not too much of a delay.
So much new equipment for 2020.
Yeah. We got budget approval. So new cameras incoming.
Spending them dollars.
Yep. A new tabletop. Very excited about. Got the new 4K capture card.
Have you decided yet what you want to do?
For cameras?
For the tabletop.
Oh, the tabletop. I had priced out something months ago when we had originally spec'd out the budget. I don't remember what it is. It's from Home Depot.
Look at those rainbow colors.
Look at that. Let me switch over to the overhead. I do have the Gordon soundboard, but it's on my box over there, so I can't really access it from here.
I think I'm going to take out this drive cage. Excuse me.
And Brent loves your t-shirt you're rocking today.
Thank you. I love it too. The in-joke is that I'm actually supposed to go do something fitness-related later today, and I'm hoping that my friend notices.
Who's it? Leslie Lai says, yes, we are based in the downtown San Francisco area. That's where this office is located.
Technically, it's not downtown.
True.
But it's close.
Then Dennis asks if I'm going to burn this old tabletop, and man, I would love to. That would be fun, but probably not a good idea.
Also,
not in the city.
I just wanted to let everyone know, because we upgraded to 4K, for the stream, it's not playing very nice with our monitors. So yeah. I don't have the steady, it's kind of doing this like flickering in and out thing.
Yeah.
So if the positioning on this isn't as clean or I have things, you know, half off your view, just let Adam know. It's because I can't actually tell where I'm putting things right now.
Yeah, I'm trying to watch it too. We have confidence monitors set up. These are old Marshall monitors, but the output in 4K is kind of messing with them, so it's not the best solution. One of the things I did not anticipate when we switched over to 4K.
Oh, cool.
VC Jester says we should get everyone to sign the table and auction it off.
Who would want to buy it?
Yeah, you'd have to come here and pick it up.
You don't want to buy it. Trust us on this one.
Yeah.
You really don't.
Yeah.
It's not worth it.
And thank you, Brad, for taking care of whatever spam is happening in our chat.
Oh, yeah, I forgot Brad's joining us on the chat.
Oh no, Brad. Brad's here. Yes, he's been helping us out
in
chat. Thank you so much, Brad. I appreciate it because since it's just me and Elena, we're, it's harder to pay attention to both what's going on and what's going on.
You don't know how excited I am that this build is so simple.
And actually, this is a 1440p, 24 frames a second, or 23976. Because that's how I roll. Not much of a 60p person for cameras. Gaming, yes. Cameras, no. Oh, Brad says he's going to get a finger cramp over here with all these spam accounts.
That's weird. Why would we get so many spam accounts on this particular?
I locked it down a while ago. A while ago, man, we were getting them all the time in our
full nerd.
Yeah, in the full nerd, just spam accounts coming in and out. I locked it down by making links, disabling links, because usually people don't post it links. So that actually helped a lot because a lot of the times the spam accounts would just come in and,
please,
and link to something.
Please check me out here.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh. Yes, a smooth 23976 yeah. Cinematic stream.
Oh my gosh, speaking of cinema. So I posted about this on Twitter, but one of the people that I live with decided to finally watch Star Wars. And I guess they had seen like a couple of movies here and there, but they said, you know what, I'm gonna just watch it, and I'm starting with episode one. And I didn't know how to stop them because they were already pretty much done with episode one at that point, and they were determined to go through in order, which is what I had done, and that basically neutered my ability to ever love Star Wars. I don't hate it, I don't love it, I just am indifferent to it because of that.
Does that mean they're actually going to watch Rogue One in fourth?
Oh, I don't know.
Because Rogue One is...
No, it's too late. They've been basically mainlining it.
Oh,
so
with the numbers,
they're already on four.
Okay.
They're already on four. And I was shocked because they don't, I think they don't care. I think they're watching it just because it's an option. It's available. But they didn't really seem to take away much from the first, the prequel trilogy, other than that they were confused about Padme's role. They're like, I thought she was queen, but now she's a senator? I don't know what's really happening.
She was the queen of
Naboo,
that world.
Wasn't it?
Naboo, yeah. But then she became a senator.
No, I know, yeah, but yeah. It was just funny to me that they were retaining very little of, what Lucas really wanted to impart to us.
I mean, yeah. Also, I think a lot of it plays off nostalgia. So I remember, and I still think it's a cool moment, when Yoda whips out a lightsaber for the first time. And it's just like, oh yeah, here you go.
That was very fan service-y.
That was awesome.
I remember the entire theater cheered when I watched it.
Oh, hell yeah. Oh yeah. No, I mean, I still get goosebumps. It's fun. But I don't think that it's nearly as hard if you're just watching it from one. You're just like, oh, okay, cool. This guy uses a lightsaber. Dennis is asking what I think of the McDonald's fish burger. Last time I tried it, the tartar sauce was good, but like I said, just McDonald's, everything from the bun to the patty is just like flavorless for the most part.
Can you actually register anything that's not a punch to your face?
What?
In terms of flavor, not that you're gonna have to
report
me to
HR. Are you trying to tell me
the
McDonald's buns have a lot of flavor?
I'm just saying that for somebody who claims that Taco Bell is the thing, I can't use the language I want to use on this stream. And
I'm not saying Taco Bell has more flavor.
Then why would you prefer it?
Well, I mean, I guess if I had, I mean, I like Mexican food. I mean, I'm not saying it's Mexican food, but I also like the semblance of Mexican food. You know, it's just easier to eat.
Hold on, I can't actually keep building right now.
But yeah, I'm going to say if it comes to a burger, Burger King's my burger of choice.
Really?
For fast food. I just realized there's like a piece of dirt on the lens.
Oh.
See it right there? Look at that. It's like, dang it. Right there. Weird. anyway, sorry. I'm a Burger King kind of guy when it comes to burgers.
Not even In-N-Out.
Oh, you know what? Burger King does serve a fish sandwich. I gotta say, I have had a fish sandwich that wasn't McDonald's. and that I was like, okay, that's fine. I don't really remember. I'll say of the chains, of like the big national wide chains, because In-N-Out is just regional.
Have you tried the other ones, like White Castle and other things that we don't normally have here?
Yeah, I've tried White Castle once, but it was in Vegas, and it was on the old strip, and it was one of the worst things I've ever eaten in my life.
Okay.
It was not a good experience.
Okay.
Yeah, but also I wasn't high or drunk. So
okay.
I've heard that's usually how people want to enjoy that. If we're talking about large fast food chains, Burger King, Taco Bell, boom. If we're talking about regional chains,
Del Taco.
I mean, Del Taco, hell yeah. In-N-Out. I mean, In-N-Out's good, but it's not my favorite burger.
In-N-Out's an okay burger, but their fries are garbage. I don't know.
Their fries.
I don't know why people like their fries
so much.
It's
an okay burger, but it's also a cheap ass burger, which is great. So you got to know going in that it's not necessarily the best burger, but it's the best for how damn cheap it is, in my opinion. And the fries are just nasty. They're a vehicle for salt. Whataburger, you know, I actually haven't had enough Whataburger to make an opinion on that. But I will say another regional favorite that I actually miss was Rudy's barbecue from, Austin. They have them there. They have them in Phoenix. They have them in Denver.
I think I saw that one of the airports I was in recently.
Oh, Rudy's! I love Rudy's for fast Texas style barbecue.
How do you define Texas style barbecue?
Texas style is usually a dry rubbed meat with very minimal.
There is no hope for cable routing here.
Barbecue sauce, something like a Georgia style or even a Kansas style is very slathered in barbecue sauce.
Ooh.
And I prefer to.
No, I'm on board with Texas then.
Yeah, I prefer to taste the meat rather than the barbecue sauce because I always feel like when there's a lot of barbecue sauce, it's like hiding bad meat.
Mm-hmm.
So you know.
Totally agree, 100%.
That should be.
We are aligned on this one. Still don't understand the Taco Bell thing, but I can get on board with this.
Somebody's saying you should route power through the back, but actually that back panel doesn't have a ton of room in it.
I could take off that side panel, but this build really isn't about this.
Yeah, a budget build, you know, whatever. Also, GeForce
Now. If you are watching this as a guide, yes, I would take their advice and take off this side panel here and route the cable a little bit so it's not just dangling here, but for our purposes, it doesn't gotta be pretty.
You know, I've actually never tried Checkers / Raleigh's. I've heard of Raleigh's, but I've heard of it before. Never
okay,
tried
so
it.
Okay, so I got CPU power. I got 24
and Hardee's / Carl's Jr. You know, Carl's Jr.
Carl's Jr. isn't bad.
It's not bad. I don't think
it's not good.
I would say it's better than McDonald's, but
that's not saying much
because everything is.
Wait. What's your stance on the McRib?
I mean, it tastes like cardboard.
You and Brad are going to have some words.
Yeah, I mean, it's fun, sure, but yeah, I don't know. It's whatever. The one thing, the thing I liked most about Carl's Jr. is their ad campaign for if it doesn't get all over the place, it doesn't belong in your face. I think some of those ads were really funny.
Oh, man. That does sound like something you would enjoy.
Yeah, I think it's hilarious. And no, there will be no cable routing. This is just, you know,
no,
we're just doing it.
Super chill.
Yes.
Super relaxed. Super don't care.
I don't know who doesn't love a stream of the top of a woman's head. Those are my favorite streams too.
Do I need to report you to HR now?
No, it was in the chat.
I've always wondered about this because it happens when Gordon is doing it too, and you just see nothing but his head. But I haven't really seen many comments about it. But
I mean, it happened. That's why I tried to move the camera a little further forward so that.
I mean, I don't want you all seeing the top of my head. Yeah. No one needs to see whatever bald spot I'm developing. Sheesh.
Also, friend of the show Ashen is asking about the 10-minute gameplay trailer of Atomic Heart. I have not watched it yet.
Oh, I don't even know that game.
Yeah, I actually don't know either.
Wow, I'm really out of the loop.
I've tried Steak and Shake. No, I'm thinking, wait, Shake Shack, wait, Steak and Shake, Shake Shack. I don't think I've had Steak and Shake. I've had Shake Shack, but that was only once, I think. Sonic, yeah, I like Sonic.
I've never been to Sonic.
There's something fun to have to have that like drive up
so
old diner experience where you eat in the car. I mean, I typically don't like it because eating in the car is not fun. I would much rather spread out at the table. Time. But it's still kind of fun, especially as a kid. Like, we would do it, and it was a fun little thing.
There you go. I can word today.
But man, they have really good tater tots. And my wife, loves.
Did you say tater tots?
Yeah, Sonic has really good tater tots.
Oh, I'm so there.
Yeah.
We don't have any in the Bay Area, though, do we? Because I think I only seen them in Sacramento when I was up there.
Yeah, maps.google.com. Let's see, Sonic.
You know what, Dennis? I'm digging this whole let's talk about food thing. I'm hungry, but I still dig this.
The closest one is Union City.
That's all the way, like, by Fremont.
Yeah, it's right off the... right off the 238. So, I mean, it's doable, but it's a drive.
That was a very Jersey accent there.
Doable. Also, it looks like, interesting. I've never heard of this. There's a drive-in in the Mission called Whiz Burgers Drive-In.
Time to consult the motherboard manual for these pins.
Oh, you're looking for the pin layout?
Yeah,
there's one in...
phone.
Looks like there's one in.
Are we getting
Antioch,
a visit from Gordon? I hear the door.
And one in.
Hey,
Vallejo.
It's a Gordon.
There he is.
Did you guys lock that door open?
No.
Did we lock the door open?
Other side.
No.
Open.
Oh, I haven't been to the other side today. Good to see you too.
Bye.
VC Jester is talking about a place called Taco John's. Never seen that.
I'm not familiar with that.
There was a place, Taco Time, in Salt Lake City that had really good Mexican style tacos. If you don't want anyone to see your phone, it's in the front.
Yeah, just in case don't do any identity theft, please.
Dennis is asking about fishing since we live near the ocean. Fun fact, there's not actually that great of fishing in the Bay Area.
That's not true.
I mean, compared to somewhere up north, Portland or Seattle.
You
hey, there he is.
Snob.
What's going on, Gordon? So nice gloves.
We're
just still building.
Where did the CPU store here? Oh, that's the other way.
That's the 1200.
What's going on? Why don't you come say hi? Get on this.
People have been asking about you. They don't want us. They want you. No.
Yeah. They just all assume that you're testing 64-core Threadripper. That's why you've got the gloves on. It's so many cores, you got to like put gloves on to hold on to it, right?
Yeah.
It's
a real delicate procedure.
We'll see.
Have you ever gone fishing in the Bay Area?
Yeah. What kind of fish?
I don't know. The stream's asking if any of us go fishing.
Well,
anytime you go fishing in the Bay Area, there are signs saying don't eat fish from the Bay Area. Or if you do, only eat so much. Remember, the Bay Area was, they just dumped all the lead and selenium and just all the heavy industry into the Bay for years. So you basically don't want to eat anything actually out of the bay.
Too late.
I know up north there's a lot of good oysters and kind of shellfish kind of stuff.
Yeah.
For sure. So
yes.
If you're into that kind of thing.
Nothing like the ocean's filtration system, eating that.
Yeah, why not? That's where you get the
So Gordon
the flavor,
does not
right?
eat raw oysters.
No, I have. There was a really great place up in the... They got shut down by the government, though.
Oh, great.
Of course.
Yeah, they wanted their land back, so they shut down.
I guess
eminent domain, huh?
Was it theirs?
It was theirs. They had been basically growing oysters there for decades, and then the government, for some reason, who knows? Who knows why? If you go out through the bay, if you deep sea fishing is really good.
The deep sea fishing is pretty good.
Okay. Yeah.
Never why you want to go fishing?
No, the just chat was asking about fishing in the bay.
My father was a huge fisherman, so I don't like to fish at all. But I like fishing.
Did your dad drag you out? Is that why?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, I have memories of being a kid and watching all the Beta Breakers people. And I was, God, I'd have been like 6 or 7. And there were guys running by in their Speedos. And I turned to my dad and I said, Daddy, why are they running in their underwear? He did not stop laughing for like 5 minutes.
Yeah, Beta Breakers is a bay to breakers. Like you're going from the bay to the breakers. I remember the first time I heard that, I was like, beta, B-E-T-A, like a fish, beta breakers.
Hey, I think we're good to go.
Like I was like, why are they breaking betas? Like that's just mean, but that's not how it's spelled or pronounced.
So I have to ask, how much do the operating system cost?
You hungry?
I'm sorry,
hungry.
What? Yeah, I'm hungry.
We should get some food. Do you want to order pizza?
I gotta go move stuff.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Cool. Good seeing you.
Yeah.
What?
What?
Oh, sorry. I got some questions from the chat. 9800K. Nope. We're doing a Athlon 3000G in this. She did upgrade the BIOS, so it should work fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I assume.
Oh, but guess what? Still has a drive cage or drive bay.
Oh, that's good.
Just one. The other budget we had in the option
for
had three.
Let's hook this up to a TV.
Yeah, all right. That's fun.
It's time. I don't think I've built this fast in a while, and I was going pretty slow.
That was pretty fast.
I'm going pretty slow. I wasn't like trying to race or anything.
Okay, well, let me...
Leisurely.
So there's no more overhead shot? We don't need the overhead anymore?
No, I mean, when we put in the 570 later, I think people really know how that goes. It's fine.
I'm going to risk pulling this cable without killing somebody. Cool. That went okay.
And then that's when Gordon got beamed in the head.
This is,
What's going on, Gordon? We're going to play some GeForce Now. Maybe some,
Make sure you don't show the login issue.
We already logged in. Yeah, just as a side note, we prepped the SSD with Windows, so.
So Windows is Windows 10, 1909 is installed already, and we already installed GeForce Now and Steam. However, we don't have the games ready for Steam yet, so we may have some time to, you know, talk about food.
How big is the SSD?
512.
How much is the price for?
That one. Well, the Corsair that I spec'd out, I think, is running about 40 right now. I have to look at my laptop where I have the parts list. Let's move this off. Toss those in here.
Ow.
You okay?
Yeah. Oh. Jeez. All right. That's what I needed. This is, for all those that are wondering, this is the stupid micro to full HDMI adapter that broke. Two of them broke this morning.
What?
Yeah, this is why I was troubleshooting for half an hour. Yeah.
Okay.
I was just not getting a signal, and I was like, what the hell? Is it this new 4K capture card?
Do they break on you often?
Yeah, these things, it's because the kind of tension we put on it, I'd rather have the cable break than the actual port on the camera.
Makes sense.
So, I mean, they're like a dime a dozen, so not a big deal, but I only had one extra backup. I need to buy another pack of 20. What was I doing? Oh, yeah.
You know that the monitor's been freaking out since yesterday.
Yeah, it's the 4K.
Play nice.
Yeah. I think it's one of those things I need to try to troubleshoot, figure out a workaround of some sort. That was in switching to our 4K capture system, that's the one thing I did not anticipate having a problem with.
I did unscrew this, didn't I? Oh. Overzealous.
So, and then you need an HDMI cable.
So how much was the case and the power supply? I mean, that was...
So the case costs $45 on, I think, Amazon or Newegg right now.
You want to plug this in?
Yeah, please.
It's stock fan, too.
Actually, we have a problem. The I.O. shield is blocking the HDMI.
Is it really?
Yeah. You see that little lip right there?
Oh. Something got...
It almost got kind of jammed a little bit.
It did. All right, let me.
Correct.
That's okay. No problem. My fault.
Just bend the IO shield out of the way.
I mean, I could, but I mean, it won't take a moment. I mean, if I had, I could try.
Oh, that's weird.
I think what happened is this part like got fold it out. It's weird. I'm gonna have to bend it back in. I guess that's what happens when you keep reusing parts over and over and over again.
It happens.
It's just funny that it doesn't look like
I think you're giving them a good view of your backside, by the way.
So, yep.
I think it's,
Oh, for some reason my live chat window froze.
You're not getting too many comments this time, or you're not surfacing them.
No, we were. I just, for some reason, my chat froze. Let's reload YouTube. I think we're still live.
I hope we're still live.
Yep, we're still live.
What time did you start?
Around 11:15-ish.
Yeah, I mean, it pushed live at 11, but
I was actually still taking apart the system, so probably I've been building for about 45 minutes.
Yeah.
I don't know. But I haven't been going very quickly either. We've been chatting.
Yeah, chitty-chatting.
Oh, I'm not centered again, huh?
Well, we're not overhead anyway.
Oh, that's right. I forgot.
I had to unplug it. Cool. Sweet.
Hiya.
Oh, Gordon, how you doing? You hungry?
Do you want to order pizza?
It might be a little too late at this point.
Is it? It's 12:19. I'm sure we're going to be testing for at least another 40 minutes.
So, but the idea here is basically a cheap computer that you would use for GeForce Now and maybe some light-duty gaming on the APU?
I mean, if that's all you have available, yes. Really, the 3000G is best suited for home theater PCs, light office work, but because it has the integrated graphics, I thought I'd give it a shot, see what it's like. I know other people have done builds like this already, but so I specifically would like to see how it does with GeForce Now.
It does make it interesting.
Obviously, there's going to be titles that it can't play.
So I downloaded locally. The GeForce Now client on my P1, my Lenovo P1, just to load it up and see. So I was wondering, like, what in my Steam library, which I have like almost 1,000 games, like which ones were, you know, in there or not. Uh-huh. It was a pretty good smattering of stuff.
Like, only worth $5 a month, right?
Well, I mean, but even free, you know what I mean?
Oh, like, free, yeah.
Like, I mean, come on, that the free thing, you know, like, sure, it's an hour, like, queue session that is annoying, but you're literally using their power. I mean, you're using all their stuff for free.
For free.
Like, I mean, so it sucks, but also it's free. You can't really complain.
I mean,
you know,
it's
can complain.
You can always complain. Yeah,
but it just feels like they're just killing it, because who's going to try to step up to compete with that? Except for maybe Microsoft, because they get that Xbox.
I mean, Stadia does have a free option coming at some point.
But still,
theoretically,
you're looking at,
that's what they say.
What? How many games?
Interesting.
I mean, what the official support list, quote unquote, was like 300. Is that what it was? GeForce Now.
But see, the thing is, like, for GeForce Now, if you have basically, if they've hacksawed off. Because most Mac people who want to play games now, and you're going to want to stream it, are you going to do GeForce Now, which is a lot cheaper, a lot more games? Or are you going to do that steep buy-in for Google? I just don't. It seems like Stadia is like in a weaker position now, you know, at this point. But you know, they can fix it with money. But are they willing to fix it with money?
Yeah, I don't know. It's they need to figure some stuff out. And for some reason, my Yelp is not working.
Huh. So in case people are curious, there's these two little cushions. They're little bits of foam wrapped with a little bit of, I don't know what it is. I don't think it's metallic, but it's some kind of outer, not foil, kind of wrapper, and it got squished when I shoved this in earlier. So that's why That's why it was blocking the HDMI. And now I might be doing the same thing to one of the USB ports. Nope, I'm good. Okay, we're good to go. I'll just screw this back in.
Where are we? Okay.
We are at work.
Yep. We are at work. Pizza delivery. sorry, I'm not.
He's ordering his food. I hope you all understand.
And I always forget where we get it from.
Do you think it makes sense to do this or just do a cheap laptop?
$300 for a cheap laptop is not going to get you.
They do say Chrome. They do say Chromebook support's coming for GeForce Now.
Did they really say that?
Yeah.
That would be impressive.
Like, I mean, that's. They say it's coming. I mean, who knows? Like I said, they have a lot of things they could grow into: 4K, HDR, high refresh rate, Chromebooks. You know.
No, what I'm saying is cheap. $300, like an Acer E15. That's a low-end core part with. Yeah, hard drive. You can upgrade to that M.2, but they're $350.
What's? Have you heard of this district? Whoops, Diamond District.
Diamond Heights.
Oh. You ever heard of that?
Oh no, MacArthur Boulevard. That would be like in Oakland, wouldn't it?
D-I-M-O-N-D. Yeah.
Oh, that's weird. Yeah, it picked up my home instead of work.
You can do it.
Yeah.
There it is. Okay.
Yeah, MacArthur is that's the only street in Oakland.
How about a
MacArthur is like a San Leandro runs the whole East
Pacino
Bay.
Well, I meant like
pizza?
It's not in San Francisco. It's not. Yeah. It's an East Bay street. It's not San Francisco. Like we have El Camino.
Whoa! Check out this.
I mean, Peninsula.
271 reviews, 5 stars. That's pretty good.
Really?
Yeah. Gusto Pinza.
What phone is that?
That's the Note 10 Plus.
Oh, nice.
More of camera testing.
With the Moment case. This I have the Moment case on this. So yeah, I'm still testing those.
I think I may go back to Samsung next time.
Yeah, you still happy with the Pixel experience?
Well, the problem is Google abandons you. Like every bit, everything you've come to expect of Google is they abandon you. They break features and they don't care about it. Like the reception's been bad for 4 months now. People have loudly complained about it, but they don't care. And their fix is apparently to buy a Pixel 4, so. Unfortunate because I had been happy.
Is the HDMI cable down there? Do you mind?
All right. Yeah, it's plugged into the TV.
Yeah. Oh.
Do you care what kind of pizza? Mm-hmm. Margarita pizza.
Oh, I got it. Boom. All right. Cross your fingers, everybody. I'm gonna get a mouse keyboard first.
Oh, let me. Yeah.
Mouse and keyboard.
And I can switch to the handy side cam.
But you grab the HDMI cable too.
Ooh. Oh, yeah.
Where's the mouse? Do you know?
Oh, yeah, it's back there.
Oh, is it? Thank you.
Or you can use that little ThinkPad thing that I use. It's really handy.
That's true.
All right, switching over to the side cam.
Oh God, moment of truth.
Keyboard.
Moment of truth. Can I? Is there a port here? Oh, there is. All right, here we go.
Booting, booting.
Well, I got fan spinning. Now everyone gets to see a black screen.
Yeah, CPU fan spinning. We're plugged into the only HDMI port it has.
I hope this is just a standard Ryzen delay on first boot. But it doesn't seem like it. Taking a real long time. Yes! Woo! It is just a standard delayed Ryzen boot. Yeah, I did, everybody!
You pronounce it ASRock, A-S-Rock?
ASRock for me.
ASRock.
Most first boots with new hardware, it has to figure it out. It's not always a Ryzen
thing. There we go. Sweet. Yeah, high five. High five. Did it.
So the driver's already loaded from previous build?
Yeah, so I used the 1200 to install all the drivers, like the display drivers and stuff like that. I got the, I need to update the Radeon Adrenaline software on this though. Yeah, we have to plug it in.
Sorry, forgot to.
Wi-Fi in here is not good.
Yeah, I really want to see how GeForce Now does.
Oops. All right. Everyone gets to hang out with us as I...
Yeah, let's hang out.
As I wait for the internet to actually... Whoa, don't drop the phone.
Good thing I have a case.
right. Come on, slow pokey.
Chad is happy that we did it.
We did it. We didn't have to do any troubleshooting or anything.
Getasu, if you look at the description of this live stream, you will see the specs of the build.
Or very close to it. Ours isn't exactly the same, but it's a very similar set of components.
Leslie's wondering if GeForce Now is going to get bottlenecked by the CPU. We'll see.
Possible.
And yes, all the drivers are installed. You, right?
I can't imagine anything slowing it down. It's just...
Do I have radio?
I mean, it feels like if you can run YouTube, you can run
GeForce. Do I not have it installed? I thought I installed it already. Let's see what's going on. Do we want to mute the TV?
Mute?
Or do we want to have
I'll turn it down a little bit.
Yeah.
You can do it right there.
It's fine, I get it.
No, I mean, she could just kill the volume.
Oh, that's true, huh?
Yeah. I mean, we want to hear at least a little bit of the game, probably. Before we get
I didn't even install Radeon software on this hard drive yet.
Whoops.
Or this storage drive yet. Y'all get to wait through the boring stuff with us.
Woohoo.
All right, I'll check later.
All right, good luck.
We'll message you when we do the GeForce Now stuff. We're going to start with the local games first.
Oh, yeah, do you want to make sure Destiny's downloading in the background?
Ooh, yes, I do.
While you're installing that. Can we install Half-Life 2? We could.
We could.
Oh, you know what? We should get Crysis.
Does it run Crysis? That's a good point.
Yeah, will it run Crysis?
Do you have Crysis in your library?
I do have it in my library.
All right, then. All right.
Though I don't know if it's part of the GeForce Now thing.
Oh. Well, it's more about seeing if it runs Crysis locally, right? So.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, sure. I don't know why your friends list came up. That was not meant to happen. You do not have regular Crysis.
Huh. Why don't I have regular Crysis? Oh, is it on Origin?
Oh.
Maybe I have it on Origin.
Oh.
I don't want to sign in Origin.
Well, we'll do that.
Oh, that's annoying.
Off the stream then. Sorry, everybody.
Yep. Sorry.
Destiny is downloading right now, though. This is also
downloading. Oh, yeah. Whoops.
Let's see, what other games can we play that's... kind of that era. Oh, I was gonna do Shadow of Mordor. Just to run the benchmark. Let me load those files.
Cool. Also, I do have in the queue waiting, I do wanna stream Temtem and Not for Broadcast. We were gonna do it last week, but stuff got ahead of us. I wanna do it with my Steam controller too. Actually, that's one of the things I want to do is test the Steam controller with GeForce Now. Because theoretically, it should work. Oh, Doom. Dennis says Doom. Somebody's asking, are the chipset drivers installed?
Possibly not. Let me do that too.
Resident Evil 4. Oh yeah, you know what? Doom could be a good thing because it has Vulkan support. It might be run a little bit better.
What is happening here? Why?
What is that? Firefox?
Yeah, it's Firefox,
and
but
it's like not
I think
scaling
it's
right.
Well, I think it's because of the TV. You know how it does the can I maximize off of here? No. Well, what's happening? I'm clicking the wrong buttons. No, it's full screen. Yeah. Things. It's a scaling thing. Do you have, can you?
Well, make sure that the display is at 1920.
Yeah.
Or 1080p, I mean.
Oh, what's happening?
Oh, you know, maybe it's just because we're installing the
I'll wait.
Graphics.
I'll wait. All right, are there any other
somebody
questions?
Somebody says F11. How you get
full screen, Nope, no thank you.
No questions right now. People are just talking about
food.
What kind of games?
Ah, here we are. Way much better.
There we go. Yeah.
I'm not sure why the scaling was so set so high.
That is weird.
What is happening?
Oh, they're construction on the
Oh, they're doing construction today.
No, not on the wall, on the benches. I think it's Luis and Gordon.
It's just weird because the hammering I can actually feel from where I'm sitting.
It's probably the big mallet. Some people are asking for Batman Dark Asylum. And hi, Lindsay. Welcome to the stream. I think it's Luis and Gordon on the other side. And the studio is not haunted, no. But yes, it sounds like a lot of people want Doom, if we can get that key.
Doom? Okay. What happened here?
Oh, it's already right there. Just two below Destiny. I have it on my favorites. Doom! Doom, doom, doom.
Oh my gosh, I hope that's actually not true, because if it takes an hour to download, it's not going to work. So the part of this stream that Adam and I didn't discuss, obviously, is which games we were going to play.
Yeah, actually, it sounds like nobody's really voting for Destiny, so maybe just stop Destiny. I think you right-click on it. No, on the download button. Or maybe on the actual name of the game. Yeah, manage, uninstall. There we go. All right.
Oh, good. Look at that. All right, let me look up my drivers.
Somebody says Fortnite. No!
Why?
Oh,
No, I mean, why are you saying no?
I don't know. And yes, Destiny is on Steam. They made the jump late last year from Battle.net to Steam because they no longer work with them.
I don't care about the audio.
Brad says, can y'all share that sweet office internet connection with me, please?
Love to. Actually, this guy just got onto, Gigabit?
Fiber? Yeah, Fiber, Sonic Fiber, whichever they used to be.
So envious.
And actually, I think this motherboard caps out at a gig Ethernet port. It doesn't have 10 gig. So we're kind of capped a little. We're not able to use the full throughput of the office here, so. And yes, Peter, we could have just preloaded the games on the SSD, but we didn't, so.
Well, we could have if I was actually able to access Adam's library before last night when I was the only one here in the office, but obviously that wasn't happening.
Yeah, not happening.
There are very few of us who actually have the vaunted press accounts.
Hi, Lindsay. Gordon has one. I don't think I'm outing them there. To say that Gordon has a Steam press account, which is nice.
So for the rest of us, we kind of have to make do with whoever's account has the game we're looking for.
Which, yeah, do you want to, somebody was asking how many games actually I have, if you want to.
871.
They're not all games, though. You can filter by
just
games, because some of that is software. If you can see where it says games
they
and software.
The interface. What? Oh, there we are.
There you go. If you just select
games. What's happening here? You only have two.
Oh. Okay, 745 games.
Wow, you really committed to PC gaming.
You know, it's one of those things where you I remember getting in on those early Steam sales and just buying a ton, and then Humble Bundle really padded out a lot of them too. I used to buy a lot of Humble Bundle stuff.
Humble Bundle was really great for that.
So I have a lot of indie stuff. It's not like I have all the big stuff.
Where is my Steam folder? Okay.
There you go. Oh, and you stopped on the Bayonetta. Just kidding.
Do they want us to play the Bayonetta?
No, nobody. I know one person who'll say that we should see the Bayonetta, but. and then VC Jester is asking if I snag all the free codes from work too. I get codes sometimes, especially if I'm going to do something multiplayer with Hayden and we require it for review. Sometimes we do get some other codes in for testing. Since I've been here, probably a couple dozen. I mean, it's. Most of my library is stuff.
Only 2%.
Ooh. 60 gigs. Whoa. Ooh.
That might take a while.
Yeah. Well.
I'm gonna skip the. I'm gonna try the LAN one just in case that changes anything.
Probably pop, yeah.
Any other questions?
No questions. Oh, stop clicking my pen. You're right.
He is such a fidgeter.
I am. Somebody's saying we could do Half-Life 2. That probably runs not too bad.
Do you have Half-Life 2?
I have Half-Life 2, yeah.
Okay.
Somebody's asking, sorry, I just started the stream. Why are we downloading games? Well, we just built this $300 gaming PC to download some games and try its power, and then we're going to load up GeForce Now and see how it runs on that.
And the reason why we didn't do it in advance was because Adam has far more games than I do, and I was prepping all of this at the office yesterday, and Adam left a little bit early to pick up from home. So I wasn't able to get the login information until this morning.
Also, Dark Age is asking if you have to install the games for GeForce Now. No. Well, yes, but no. Not locally. When you launch it, you'll see it. It brings up an interface.
Is Half-Life 2 one of those titles? Sorry, I didn't mean to.
I did not look on the list, but I would be surprised if Half-Life 2 wasn't on there. So you'll kind of log into their server instance, and then you will see, okay, your list of games that you want to play / install, and it literally installs like that. So technically you are installing, yes, but you're not installing it locally, and I think it's one of those things where it pings one of the... I don't know how server stuff works, but they're essentially pinging a server version of it and just downloading it like that, if that makes sense. Yes, and Half-Life 2 is free to play, but I already own it. And no, RTX is not going to play on something locally here, but we will try it on GeForce Now.
All right.
OFEC is wondering when we're going to install the GPU. Well, we wanted to try GeForce Now and running off of the APU first to see how that would do.
Yep, and we're hoping that we can do that fairly quick-ish.
Yeah.
So that way we can still have time to see how this runs. So one of the things I mentioned earlier in the stream when I was installing the CPU is that this Athlon 3000G and then also using an A320 motherboard, the chipset, they have combined, they don't have very many PCIe lanes. So Brad and I were talking about this before the stream, and we're not sure if this is going to step down to Gen 2x8 or Gen 2x4 on this board for that graphics card. It's one of the things that I'm really curious to see how it's going to affect performance overall.
And yes, somebody's asking about the running GeForce Now on AMD cards. Yes, because essentially you're just streaming it. So even though this is AMD CPU and we're going to throw an AMD GPU, the games aren't running locally. We're essentially just getting connecting to their servers and getting a video feed returned to us. So yes, you can run RTX on AMD hardware, essentially. Somebody's saying that that you should be able to get PCIe 3.
So I spent a lot of time on this last night trying to figure it out.
I didn't order pizza.
Oh, you didn't order pizza.
Whoops. Sorry.
We've lost 20 minutes.
All right, real quick, do you want to pick a pizza?
Yeah. Let me just finish what I was going to say, though. So I was looking into this, and so previous Athlon parts were limited to Gen 2x4, I believe. But this chip is supposed to be based off of Raven Ridge, so I don't really know what we're going to get out of it. This is one of the things I should have asked AMD directly before we started this, and I just didn't think to, so that's my bad.
And while you're looking at pizza, Dennis is asking about the movies converted from 24p to 60p on Yeah, I hate it. It's motions. Usually, a lot of TVs call it motion smoothing.
The soap opera effect is bad.
Yeah, if I get a chance when I'm at somebody's house, and I know some people would call it a really mean thing to do.
Do you turn it off for them?
I'll usually be like, oh, hey, can I see the remote for a second? And I turn it off, and they don't know. They don't even notice, but for me, it makes my experience so much better. So I'm like, hey, don't worry.
Good on you.
I'm setting it up for you.
Good on you.
Yeah, so I can't handle it. I was actually watching a movie this weekend over at somebody's house, and it was Wonder Woman, and it had the most motion smoothing on, and I was just like,
no.
Ugh. I mean, it's just, it's just one of those things people don't understand.
Do you want to build one from scratch, or do you want to just get one?
I'll literally eat anything on here.
I like this one, but I don't know how you feel about those pepper things. You might want to take them off.
Okay.
Yeah, sorry for all this boring installation stuff. I tried to do most of it, but obviously I didn't get to all of it. Yes, I would like to restart my computer now. So what we're going to do next is I'm going to download Half-Life 2. We'll get started with that. I'm going to also drop on the files from Shadow of Mordor on here just to run the benchmark, just kind of see what we're getting. And then I think after that we'll go straight into GeForce Now. That's assuming that Half-Life 2 doesn't take that long to download.
God, but given Half-Life 2 is like 6 gigs?
Yeah, given its age, it shouldn't take too long. It shouldn't be that big of a download.
So sorry, I'm going to be quiet for a second.
I'm going to grab this to see if I can look at some of the chat questions. Do we have any messages or comments in Discord or Twitch?
Oh, I don't have Discord installed on here. Sorry.
Yeah, I'll take a look.
Somebody is asking what your favorite kind of pizza is.
Me?
Yeah.
I used to really like just Italian sausage with mushroom. And then I realized the other day that I think I've converted over to salami with mushroom. I don't know when that happened. What about you?
I like pretty basic stuff. I mean, I would say for the, other than just a classic, like kind of meat lover's pizza kind of thing, I like to mix it up, like I said earlier, with a white sauce pizza.
Oh, you do?
Yeah. So Alfredo and
not sure why steam isn't
spinach
opening.
And, yeah.
I have this issue sometimes.
All right, cool. Order placed.
Sweet, thanks.
Somebody was asking if you had... Shelly was asking if you had the memory set to XMP.
You know, I haven't. You know, you're right. I should go into the BIOS and change the XMP profile. Thanks for reminding me. Which is perfect, because I just rebooted.
And somebody's saying Half-Life's only around 6 gigs, so...
Oh, perfect. Wait, Half-Life or Half-Life 2?
Half-Life 2.
Thanks, everybody.
Yeah, I've actually been, I think I mentioned this, I've been playing replaying Portal 2 on my Steam controller, which I have right here.
Oh, I think the profile is automatically loaded. Let's see. Nope. This is sweet.
Peter, I think you're talking about our previous conversation of motion smoothing. I think that's what you're talking about. Oh, if you're talking about motion smoothing, well, but this is the thing, at least scaling, so hey. If you take a 1080p signal and scale it up to 4K, you're essentially taking 1 pixel's worth of information and making that fill in 4 pixels because the math is essentially scales like that. So you're not actually recreating any new information. You're just making that 1 pixel into 4. So you're just making it bigger. But for motion smoothing, you're literally taking 24 frames of film, and then you have to make 60 now. So what it does is in between each frame, it adds extra frames and tries to like say, okay, well, between these frames, we gotta create some new frames with the information we have. So it kind of smooths them in between and kind of like, it's literally trying to create something that's not there based off of the two frames that are in between it. And it just doesn't look good.
Kaz MC in Discord says to you, Adam, just say no to Taco Hell.
I love Taco Bell. It's true. And yes,
shaking my head.
The paid version.
Oh. I wait for that to connect.
The paid version of GeForce Now right now has a 3-month free trial, and then the $5 a month after that will kick in.
Right.
So we'll see when what the price will jump up to, what they're going to do later, but they haven't said.
It'd be cool if they kept it at $5 a month, but I don't know if they would be able to afford doing that.
Yeah, my guess is it's going to jump up to $10, and like I said, they'll add things like 4K HDR, obviously more games by that point.
I don't understand why I can't
high refresh rate maybe.
Actually open. Like I'm double clicking.
Is it opening? Is it open in the toolbar?
No, it's not even showing in the toolbar. I don't know what's going on. Like, I almost wonder if one of the things I installed is interfering with it.
Which did you double click on it?
I did. I even did it this way.
Sometimes it just takes a second.
Shouldn't be taking this long.
Dennis says we should do World of Warships. We are not the World of Warships experts here, and I don't want to take that away from Gordon, so.
Yeah, I'm going to uninstall the previous two things I installed just to see if there's some kind of weird conflict. I'll get rid of that.
And yes, I'm sure Gordon has a copy of it.
Copy what?
World of Warships on his laptop.
If I can't get this to work, I think we should just hop into GeForce Now, because that's really the main thing that we wanted to do today.
Yep. Yeah, okay. Oh, no. Like I said, I'm not going to rain on his parade. He's allowed to have his World of Warships. He can have fun with that. We're going to do other stuff. But yeah, Steam Controller. I actually want to do a whole thing where I'm trying out Steam Controller with GeForce Now to see if it properly loads profiles and everything.
You're going to use that with this?
I mean, we don't have to now. We can always do it later. I think people would probably want to see mouse and keyboard first. And Peter, no, I would still call motion smoothing a little bit different than upscaling. But, I mean, yeah, because upscaling actually can be okay in some circumstances. Motion smoothing, I probably would never recommended in any form. And then cancel Doom as well once you're starting Half-Life. Two.
Sorry, whoops, wrong one.
Oh, okay, actually, it looks like it's going straight there. Oh, okay, because you paused it, so.
Yeah, it's paused. So I'll just leave it paused.
Yeah.
Man, 60 gigs.
It's a big game. Man, I was playing it recently with my Steam controller, and woo-wee! That thing's awesome. That's fast.
Time remaining, 19 seconds.
It blazes.
Exactly what I want.
It blazes. But can it run Crysis? I don't know.
We don't know because we don't have Crysis.
I have Crysis on Origin, but not on Steam, so yeah. I mean, we could download Crysis 2, but that's not as fun.
That's not the same. I'll report back later. We'll just put a comment in the notes later. Yes, it runs Crysis, or no, it doesn't. Wait, how are we defining if it runs Crysis? Does it have to be 30 or 60? Because I don't think we're getting 60.
Whoa. Half-Life 2 is only 2 gigs? It's already done.
You ready to play?
Yeah, do it.
Is it?
Oh, do you want to bring up real quick Task Manager, just so we can see in the background? Cool. If we need to like alt tab and.
All right, it. You get to take over now.
Oh, you don't want to play?
Ugh. I never played the original. Yeah, I said it. I never played Half-Life 2.
I've played it too many times.
I don't like being scared.
Yeah, head crabs got you?
I really don't enjoy being scared. What?
The mouse.
Oh, right.
You can stay there.
It's PC gaming. Why would you need a mouse for?
PC gaming. All right, Half-Life 2. Here we go. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. Bear with me. That looks okay. All right, that did not load in 1080p. Oh, and it crashed.
Did it really?
It crashed, but also it didn't load in 1080p. Oh no, it's still there. There we go, okay. All right, video. Ooh, 720 by 576. Oh, that's weird, it's only, oh no, okay, that's fine. 16:9, show me native full screen. Should apply that first. There we go. Advanced. So it defaulted to.
It defaulted to high.
To a lot of highs. Not very high on texture. Shadow high. Simple. It's recommending that. Weird. No anti-aliasing.
When did this game come out?
Trilinear.
It's been a while, right?
It's 2004?
Yeah.
Ooh, it keeps switching away for some reason.
You might want to close up the other windows just to see if that will keep it from doing that.
All right. Hurry, 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 hurry. let's see. You know, I'll just do the.
You can actually choose where you start?
Well, because I've already beaten it.
Oh.
Does Radeon software, look at that, that's so weird. Does Radeon software do any sort of like a frame counter, like GeForce?
I think it does.
Is there a way to bring over the overlay?
Control R?
Nope. Alt R? Nope.
This Brad.
The G-Man.
Where are you,
Brad? Help.
Brad, help.
How do we get the Radeon overlay? Alt R. Not working. Nope, not working. G-Man.
You probably could just go into. There you go.
Huh, okay, well.
We can install Fraps if you want.
Yeah, it'll take overhead. Yeah, it's smooth, I can't tell. It feels, definitely VSync is off. Some screen tearing. I have the TV set to kind of low brightness because of the camera picking it up. That's why it's a little dark, but.
This is pretty smooth.
Yeah, this is pretty smooth. Is it a smooth 30? I don't know.
It feels a little bit slow, though.
Were you the only ones on that train? Oh. Yeah, that's so weird. Huh. Oh, there we go. Brad says Steam has a built-in frame counter. Oops. Ah. Steam. Settings. He says.
Oh, you got your information showing, friend.
It's settings in-game FPS counter. Settings in-game FPS counter. Top left. Cool. All right. It's not showing up.
Do you have to reload the game? Like, do you have to, like, exit out and then restart the game?
Yeah, maybe. I'll try it. I already saved it.
People in the chat are saying try Control-Shift-O.
We can see usage, at least. I mean, it wasn't pegging the CPU. The GPU was getting up there. Oh, there we go. Okay, I see it. It's very faint in the top left. You can't really see it on
screen. You can try the high contrast version. There's a setting in there that says high contrast.
How do you bring up Steam Overlay?
Oh, I always forget. I always do it by accident.
Damn it. Somebody help. Steam Overlay. Alright, so I can kind of see it. It says 200 frames?
It says supposedly it's 200 and...
It's kind of dipping down to
140, yeah.
Wow, I mean, it is an older game.
It's
and it runs on a Shield TV.
It's 16 years old at this point.
I mean, that's playable. Crack off. You should. Shift tab. There we go. Where's settings? Settings. Oh no, that's broadcast. In game.
There you go. I don't know if you're gonna have to reload the game though. Oh, there we go.
There we go.
Yep, nice bright green.
Still kind of small. You probably can't see it on screen.
We're in the 200s, right now, 264. 52.
Yeah, I mean it's smooth. It's also really dark, but that's just my settings. All right. I mean, I feel like this is one of the greatest games of all time. So, I mean, if you can play that on a $300 gaming PC,
I'm gonna need my privacy.
Yes, I'm one of those people who just hops around during a cutscene, even though I just like the idea of, you know, him trying
being
to talk to Gordon.
Guy.
Yeah, and, you know, he's just like, dude, what are you doing? You know, I'm going to see if I can max out some of these options. Video, advanced, texture detail really high.
Dennis Siberian is requesting that you load the coast map because it has more light, so it's...
Oh, yes, yes. Good call. Whoop.
Other people are giving us crap because we didn't use the console to get this all done.
Okay, new game, the coast map. Ah! Ah! Oh, I guess I have to. Alright. Yeah, sorry, it is...
Ooh, that's really dark.
It's really dark, I actually can't...
It's hard to see, yeah.
Oh. Sorry, everybody. Be outside in a second. There we go.
Impressive what you can do with that crowbar.
Yeah. I mean, we're still in like 130s.
You put everything in ultra now?
No, almost. Advanced, reflect all. Model detail, texture detail, shadow detail, shader detail. Yeah, I'm just gonna push.
Just push everything.
Yeah, desync, motion blur. multi-core rendering. Why not?
What?
Use all the cores.
See what happens. See what happens. We have dropped into the, is that 80s? Yeah, and hundreds now.
It's still.
I don't feel like it's that dramatic a difference.
Ah! All right, well, we did it. Oh, I think I used the train to get over. You know, it's been a bit since I've played Half-Life 2, but I love it.
Why do you love it?
I kind of like the minimalist story, but then also, yeah, the environments are just so expertly crafted. Oh. And I do actually do like the tension.
Oh. I know, I'm just a big wussy. Gigantic wussy.
Whoa. Who's shooting me? Oh. Where is he? There he is. All right, so what's chat saying? Should we move on?
Some people, Brent P. wanted to know if we could load a more demanding area.
Oh, I ran out of bullets.
Let's see.
I mean, I think it's gonna run pretty damn good.
I mean, it's a 16-year-old game.
Yeah. Somebody mentioned earlier that it runs pretty well on a Pentium. Which I think is true, so. I don't remember what crouch is in this other area. Alt. Secret!
Tasty.
Oh, I got an achievement. I guess last time I played it, they didn't have achievements.
Are you not a headshot kind of guy?
I mean, this isn't. Yes, but this isn't really like. Oh, crap. Gotcha. Yeah, I don't need it. Anyway, I want to try GeForce Now. Are you ready?
You want to do the GeForce Now version?
Yeah,
of this?
I mean, this is pretty damn good for.
But I mean, is game. GeForce Now really going to do that much more for it?
I mean, I just like the idea, you know, okay. Show that you can play ray tracing on a. All AMD $300 bills. Run!
Dennis Siberian is suggesting that we try Half-Life 2 Deathmatch.
Deathmatch. Yeah. All right. We did it. Don't save.
Ulfek Tsudukian, sorry, I can't pronounce your name, says that Shift plus Alt plus O is the AMD overlay.
Shift plus Alt plus O, okay. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna download Doom, or actually this will be interesting to see how GeForce Now runs with Doom.
VC Jester says, shouldn't Adam be wearing a beanie hat if we're gonna watch the game?
If we're gonna stream, yeah. I mean, technically we're not streaming, so. Also, yes, I can't stop playing Half-Life 2. It's one of those, like, it just feels good, you know? Like, it never gets old, it just feels good. All right, what do we want to play on GeForce Now?
Let's try Doom. Since we couldn't download it.
Okay. I actually want to
download it in time.
I want to try real quick to see, there is a test network. Just want to see what it says for our network stuff.
Dude, I came in during yesterday's discussion of GeForce Now, right? Yep. When Leif was discussing the bandwidth.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, how much data it uses. And it blows me away that the downgraded version is already 4 gigs in 1 hour.
Well, actually, it says right there 10 gigs
per
hour.
No, this is the standard. 10 gigs.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Standard if you do the data saver, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, like most people have pretty limited caps in the US, so yeah. That would get eaten so fast.
Right.
And I think this is still the case. A lot of people who live in more rural areas, they would go through, really, that's it? What's going on with our network?
I mean, we have corporate network, it's just not, like, I'm sure some firewalls are in place that are...
Yeah, we used to have NAT issues. Oof. When I used to work at OXM.
Yeah.
It would be really hard sometimes to get into multiplayer matches.
Yeah. Somebody's asking, we should do something with RTX. So I don't know what on this list is RTX. Yeah, it looks like frame loss.
We have a vote for...
Oh, you know what it is? I need to pause. Let me try it again.
Oh, it's...
I'll pause Doom. Try
wait,
again.
Wait, it's...
I was downloading Doom. It's not going to stop it because, you know, it's Steam.
That's
it's
funny.
Separate, so, yeah.
So we have a vote for Quake Champions. We have a vote for Assassin's Creed Odyssey.
Anything with RTX?
Someone voted for Apex Legends.
Yeah. I would do Metro. I mean, Metro has RTX, but it's also really, really dark. It's just not going to show up that well.
What about Wolfenstein? Or Call of Duty?
Oh, yeah, Youngblood. So actually, I don't own Youngblood. Oh, there we go. Okay, now it's better. But it's weird.
But it's still capping us at 720.
Your network supports a streaming max resolution of 720p.
That's crazy.
Why would I? Huh.
What about...
Okay.
What if he? I guess it doesn't matter.
Yeah. I don't. I do not own Youngblood. Unfortunately. I mean, I could buy it real quick. But I mean, let's try Metro. I think I can find like an outdoor bright.
Let us
part.
Know if you can't see it. We'll.
Quake 2 RTX. Yep. Yeah. Microsoft Game Store games on GeForce Now. I don't think. I don't think it works. I don't think they have any of them. Oh yeah, so Brett said Metro. So we're loading into their instance now. Oh, I forgot I have to sign in for the Epic Game Store.
Let's just.
It's fine. I don't think it actually shows it.
Just in case.
It doesn't show it.
You sure?
Yeah. Okay. Need to bring up my password manager.
If you're not using a password manager, you really should.
Might even ask me for a. And my email is public, it's whatever. You're not getting anything special there. On my website. Newer local file. We've detected a cloud sync conflict. Local file? Why do I have a local file?
Yeah, why do you have a local file?
Why do I have a local file? Oh, what? That doesn't make any sense.
What is today? Today's the 5th. Yeah, just ignore that. Just use your cloud. What is going on with the resolution here?
It's 720p.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
So does GeForce Now actually automatically cap you at what it thinks you can do?
No, I mean when I tried at home, it was telling me from the full 1080p. So it says Metro's running. Oh, there we go. Just took a minute. Yep, it's a weird.
What is going on with the?
Oh, there we go. Okay, I've had that problem before.
So we're really limited to 720.
I guess, thanks to corporate. I wonder
oh,
if Gordon
okay,
had
sorry.
That same problem
go
too.
Back. Imran Shadowfax says you have to change GeForce settings on custom settings instead of balance, which I was wondering, but. I didn't actually say anything out loud.
Okay.
Thanks, person.
Why is this not letting me? Gotta wait through this for a second.
So, Devon Gannis asks, what's the benefit of using a password manager? I don't like the idea of storing the keys to everything in one place.
That is true, but there are ways around it. So if you really don't want to do like cloud storage of password management, you can do something like a KeePass file that you keep within your, like say, Google account, which is still in the cloud, but Google has definitely very good security, and the password manager file is encrypted as well. The benefit to it is just that you can do more complex passwords and you can have unique passwords for everything, so that way if, you know, one service gets breached, which invariably something does these days, then you're not at risk for being hacked other places. And also you don't have to deal with, I mean, everyone nowadays easily has anywhere from 100 or more, 100 and up when it comes to number of passwords. It's not good security to just even do variations where I know people that will say, oh, I have like a base password and then I add on something to it to make it different. I mean, that's not too hard to figure out what the pattern would be if you're doing it fairly simple.
Kind of hope I don't have to sit through that loading screen next time I load it up.
Oh, you have to go through this whole loading screen first?
I don't know. Hopefully it's just the first time thing, but.
Quentin, silly boy, says, best way to keep passwords safe is to write them on a post-it and stick it to your monitor. Living up to your name, sir, or madam, or whatever. I don't actually know what the non-gendered pronouns are, or a word would be for that. Dennis Siberian, we do have pizza on the way. I'm excited for this.
Oh yeah, I should double check.
Have I Been Owned is a great resource.
Okay.
So you gotta exit out, right? So
yeah.
You try to change all this?
I have to reboot anyway with RTX, so I'm just gonna. So it's running at 1080 quality, extreme motion blur. RTX is already on. Even hair works. Wow, okay. Tessellation, everything. It's already ready already. Okay, so quit game.
We are being asked if we're gonna run CSGO. I don't think we're gonna do that. Because I actually would like to get the 570 in here and see what kind of, you know, kind of performance we get out of it.
There we go, yeah.
What's the frame rate drop down?
60 or 30.
Do you have to choose?
No. I don't think so. Okay.
And you're gonna leave VSync on?
Yeah. I mean, it's not like we're doing high refresh rate anyway, and I don't like screen tearing. Somebody says I should turn off VSync, but we'll test this, see what if it gives us an error, being like, oh, we don't like this.
Hardware Geek in Discord is saying that we should try to use Steam to show system specs on GeForce Now. Try to play on RTX T10-8 base server.
Oh, look. It didn't give us any problems. Okay. Let me do Metro real quick. Just to show that we're playing RTX on an AMD APU. At full.
Yeah, it's saying that you can launch Steam. Harbor Geek is saying, aka Big Mama, saying that you can launch Steam on GeForce Now and in Steam check hardware info. Some GeForce servers have different specs, like some are on Xeon 2697 version 4 and some on the new Intel CC150 at 3.5 gigahertz.
Sorry, just checking on the pizza.
Pizza! So excited for this.
Still at least half an hour.
Really? They actually are giving you an update?
I mean, it's a wide window.
I'm so hungry.
Oh, look at this. Weird. Oh,
that's so strange. Like, it keeps
saying. Oh, you know what it is? Because each time we're probably loading into a new instance, so it's mm-hmm. like, hey, I don't think you would ever want to.
Because that's happened a minute ago.
Yeah, yeah. I bet. because I loaded a couple Steam games last night and I didn't see any problems with Steam, but I wonder if that's a limiting thing of Epic Game Store. Is that it has cloud saves, but it's trying to have a local one or something? I don't know. That is interesting. I was gonna send our contact at NVIDIA a quick question about like streaming and stuff like that, like trying to capture a stream, you know, and see if they have recommended ways of doing it. So obviously we're just streaming off of a TV, so we're not here for the best quality. And no, I've never tried pizza with anchovies. Not necessarily against it, but oh man, you're gonna make me sit through this again.
Oh no. Looks better though.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Looks so
you probably
much better.
Can't tell. But it's already looks a little better. I mean, I wouldn't call Stadia that much easier than this. I mean, you're just downloading a client and then signing into your account. Depending on whether you're on Steam, the game is on Steam or Epic Game Store. Yeah. No! Oh, oops.
What did you do?
I triggered something.
What did you do?
I hit all the buttons. So.
What did you do?
Anyway, you never played Metro, right?
I played the original Metro. I didn't get as far in as I wanted to because at the time I was busy reviewing other games. I really love it. I love that accuracy matters. I love that, you know, you kind of have to really think about your shots because you don't know when you're going to find more bullets. The original Metro, I kind of actually liked the tension. But I still don't do well with it. I get very stressed out when I play, which is why I didn't get really deep into it. But some of the early stuff where you're just going around and you're just dealing with other human beings was fine.
I think it's interesting. It's if for those who can't see, it's using about 30% CPU and mid 20s GPU. But the Ethernet, like when it was playing that cutscene, it was using 10 megabit per second. Right now, it's down around 2, 2.5, but it's a static screen, so there's not much to show. And memory utilization is about 54%. So I mean, running this client.
That's
still takes
good.
A little bit, but that's still, I mean, good. On a $50 processor, is that what it is?
Yeah.
Is it heating up at all?
What do you mean?
Just kidding. CPU.
Oh. I mean, I have hardware monitor here if you want to actually see what the temps are on the CPU. Or on the APU, rather.
I mean, if somebody does, let us know, but loading into this, I mean, it's kind of a Metro thing. I feel like there was probably a way to hold a button and like skip past stuff, but
I really
I don't know
like
why
how good this looks
every time.
It's a little slow to respond though.
Yeah. All right. So chapters. Let's see.
Everyone was telling you to hold E to skip the
the intro. Sorry.
Sorry, I wasn't paying attention to chat either. So.
Does anyone know which level is bright enough? Spoilers if nobody's finished it.
I know there's nice.
There's one that's like in a desert. It was like after you first get the train.
I don't know what this means because I haven't played the game yet. Sorry, yeah. I'm touching my mic. Cannon Wright says, play A Hat in Time just for leap and giggles.
Oh, I don't even know if I have that. Yeah, oh god, I don't know which level's which. Autumn. Somebody's saying Autumn. Is that a bright enough one? Caspian is the desert one, is it?
You can just give it a shot, and if it's not, we can always back out of it, right?
Yeah. Okay, Caspian. Yeah, I already beat the game, so.
Also, Adam, someone gave you a compliment in chat. They said, do you want to hold ETH, see if you want to skip that?
It's still loading, don't
they? Oh, it is? Okay. Andy S. says, Adam, you are the master of transitions. I really appreciate you keeping the full nerd on track.
Sometimes. I try.
Says the guy who always asks a question in the beginning that takes us off the rails.
Usually. I haven't done too much.
You haven't done it too much recently, but that used to be your thing.
Usually I use it for housekeeping or just to say something silly. I would think these load times would be a lot better if you're using the power of the cloud. My computer loads quicker than this. But
well,
hey,
I mean,
if it was free, I mean, this is the paid account, but yeah.
I also do wonder how much the hardware itself, you know, kind of limits some of the loading.
There it is. Also, it's not linear. You saw it go from like 19 to 80 to then 100%. All right. Okay, there we go, yeah. I'm just gonna switch over back over to Task Manager. Ethernet's showing about
14 and 15 megabits per second.
Yeah, so it's actually a little bit more than they're showing, or they recommended, but yeah, CPU's holding at like 30, GPU 25, memory 51. Oh, spoilers. Yeah. All right. I mean, visuals-wise, doesn't look too bad. I see a little bit of ghosting, but could be also the TV. I mean, this is not a nice TV. This is pretty old TV, so.
It's not as crisp as I thought it was going to be.
Well, I wonder. Actually, you know what? I should check to see if DLSS is on. That would be dumb. Oh, it's not even an option. No DLSS. Huh. They must have a special version that doesn't even give you the option. Huh. I mean, especially if you look at the text, you see the edges aren't like super sharp.
Yeah, I mean, in general, to my eye right here, but it might be the TV, it looks a little soft.
Yeah, I think
like the colors are a little muddy.
Yeah, I mean, I want to try this on
an actual good monitor.
Yeah, stuff I'm like used to. I mean, it's one of those things, kind of like music. You know, it's like you know how it sounds compared to something else because you've listened to it forever.
Yeah, but you know, to be frank, if you spent $300 on this because you'd rather have a PC instead of you know a console, which is a thing that Gordon brings up constantly, then being able to play this isn't so bad.
Yeah, no, I mean, come on. We're playing Metro with RTX on a $300 machine.
So you have a more sensitive eye to this. Can you actually tell that RTX is on?
I'd have to look at shadows. Yeah. Yeah, especially around the foliage. Part of it, like especially in an instance like this, ooh, spotty connection.
Ooh.
You see that pop up?
Yeah.
Interesting. God, I can't. Yeah. Yeah. I'm trying to find a good example of light bouncing off of a surface and bouncing back into a shadow.
Somebody in the chat.
Kind of see it a little bit here.
Stephanie says that Metro Exodus is slow. I tried Destiny 2 yesterday; it was much faster. Probably depends on the game.
Interesting. I mean, it's already a kind of a sluggish game, especially like right now that I'm just trying to. I forgot how to bring up my flashlight. Damn it! It's been forever.
Ziv actually was curious what the CPU temps are.
Is there a way to bring that up easy?
Not easy. You have to stop the game and then bring up a hardware monitor. So if you can bring up the desktop.
This one?
Yeah. Give it a second. It has to. There you go.
CPU temp 35C.
not bad, but you know, keep in mind that we do have the side off right now.
And it's, yeah, it's just going straight up, unimpeded.
Basically running this like an open,
Let me out.
How does it feel?
I mean, yeah, it feels a little molasses-y, but yeah. To be fair, this, like when you're sitting here like going through these story moments anyway, it's gonna feel like that. It's not really, it doesn't really like fully unhinge until you can get outside and do your thing. There it is, okay. Now I can go outside. I mean, it's smooth. Yeah. Yeah, it's a... Could also be the sensitivity. Oh yeah, pretty low sensitivity. Let me turn that up. Oh, okay. Yeah, that feels actually pretty good. Yeah, you see a little bit of micro-blocking in the shadows when I move it real quick like that. And especially at like a long distance, you can kind of see like on that tree, that edge is kind of shimmering a little bit.
I like the cloud effects.
I mean, it's a beautiful game, yeah.
But the effect on the clouds right there actually reminds me of one of the hikes that I took last year.
Oh, that shimmering's a desert effect, maybe. I forgot that they have that heat. God, I forgot all my weapons on this. I think you have to hold down. God, what do you hold down to charge it up? No.
Jonathan Hill says, it's not stressing the CPU at all, to be honest. GeForce now runs fine on a toaster.
There it is. Yeah. That guy right there. Is that creepy? Elena? This guy right there hugging the wall.
Wait, what?
You see him hugging there's his arm. His
what?
Hand right there. Yeah, when I get closer, he'll pop out. Yeah, so I'm definitely seeing some ghosting. But, you know. For free on a $300 PC.
I mean, it's not free though, well, because we're playing with the premium version.
Yeah.
Right? So
well, the premium version is just the RTX though. So I mean, technically we'd still be getting the 1080p.
We would, but you wouldn't be getting the prettier kind of effects that you were commenting on just a moment ago.
Oh, crap.
It does actually, watching you, feel molasses-y.
Yeah.
Especially compared to Half-Life 2.
Oh,
just
yeah.
A moment ago.
Well, I mean, that was also uncapped, the high refresh rate. I mean, this is definitely locked in. But it's not, I mean, the thing that gets me more is like if there's like stutters and stuff, it's not really stuttering too much.
Oh, you're gonna make me motion sick doing that.
Anyone saying anything else testing wise?
Dennis Siberian was curious if you lowered the graphics settings, if you would get better latency.
Lower it in the game?
Ziv said that the character you just pointed out, he just wants a hug.
Yeah, he's just hugging the wall, you know.
He just wants a hug.
Oh boy, wow, you can definitely... So I changed the resolution in the game to 720. You can definitely tell that.
Ooh.
The latency...
It does seem a little faster, though.
It's faster, but...
The latency's
the same. I'm not feeling it be any smoother, necessarily. And actually, you know what's going to take more of a I'll leave it at 1920 by 1080. I'm going to drop quality down to high.
TechFusion AZ says that 120 frames per second at 720p is an option GeForce Now if you choose the competitive option. So we did the custom. If you go to competitive, you
I didn't think they had high refresh rate. Wow.
No, we can always give it a shot.
Yeah. Huh, interesting. Oh, turn off VSync, yep, good point.
Yeah, you did put VSync on because you said you didn't really like screen tearing.
Yeah, and I put VSync on at the GeForce Now level, but if I turn it off in here, I don't need them on both, yeah. Oh, sorry, I just want to make sure the food's not here.
Pizza. So for latency, it's Stefan recommended that we might want to actually change settings in GeForce Now, not the game itself.
Oh. Yeah, I was just curious to see, like, changing in the game itself, if there would be any impact. I mean, the resolution, yeah, definitely. Bumping the quality down.
Whew.
It's taken a while.
It is. Brad did say just a moment ago that this tends to be a slower, one of the slower shooters in general in terms of actual gameplay.
Definitely, yeah. I mean, it's I'm not expecting like a Call of Duty kind of experience. Too bad Call of Duty's not on here. That would be a good one, actually. And this is an old TV. This is a really old TV. I don't even know what brand it is because we taped it over. I mean, this has been sitting around. We just use it as the Skype TV during live shows, so I mean, by no means is this a gaming TV. This is not tuned for gaming. We're just using it because we have it. Oh, Call of Duty is on GeForce Now. Oh, okay. Well, crap.
Then I should try that.
Yeah, because Brad was
saying... And it has RTX as well.
Brad was saying that there's three games right now that support on GeForce Now. It's Call of Duty, Wolfenstein Youngblood, and then Metro.
That's what it is. Okay, yeah, Call of Duty would be good.
Yeah.
Because that one definitely... I mean, this, you know, it some of it is a little bit hard to distinguish of, like, it is a slower kind of shooter.
Also, I apologize to anybody on Twitch who's been asking questions, because I don't actually have the Twitch stream up, so if you've been asking anything,
sorry.
I have not been seeing it.
Me neither.
Let me get that up.
Okay, there we go. Do you want to save your changes being made? Yes. Oh, no, I was going to take off VSync. Yeah, okay. It definitely impacted the visuals. It feels a little less sluggish for sure.
Definitely not as pretty.
Definitely not as pretty. Yeah. I mean, I would say this kind of tracks with how I was doing stuff at home. Honestly, I'm always a big fan of looking at Digital Foundry's breakdowns. They usually kind of tell you what they recommend settings-wise. I remember when I did first pop it up, I had some of my own problems on my home machine. Okay. So I'm gonna quit this. I'm gonna go to Call of Duty.
I mean, essentially we're logged into a virtual machine. I mean, it's not a... Yeah, I don't know how to describe it, to tell you the truth.
Some people would like to see us test multiplayer.
Yeah, I'll do Call of Duty, yeah. Because that's probably the most one I'm comfortable with showing on stream. temperature, CPU still hanging at 35.
That's pretty good, honestly. That's great.
Close that stuff. What was I gonna do? Okay, got it. Thank you. Call of Duty. Wow, they got all the Call of Duties. Is this the newest one? I think so. It's weird it doesn't have the.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to tell.
I think this is the newest one. Well, we'll see if it makes me log into. Into Battle.net.
Oh.
Yep, yeah, it does.
Franz Pleurman, sorry, wanted to know, is GeForce not available for Android? Would like to install it on my rooted Amazon Fire Stick 4K.
It is. I just downloaded the app last night, but I can't confirm that it actually played, because I didn't try it out. I didn't have a...
There's definitely an installer for it, because when I was downloading the installation file for Windows, I saw one for Android. Jarek Kabaran is asking, so is GeForce now powerful enough to basically run everything at 1080p 60?
Oh crap, I didn't change the settings on this.
I believe the answer is yes.
Well, yeah. Yeah, I mean, oh crap, and I didn't go into, after this I do want to run a game, like Brad said, in Steam and then bring up hardware monitor to show what hardware. Yeah, I'm sure they're doing some trickery on the back end. It's not like you're just logging into a single machine, you know, with a CPU and a GPU. This is a server rack that we're dealing with, so.
Dennis Iberian, trust me, I'm actually really content to watch Adam play. I'm so hungry right now, I can't concentrate.
I know, right? Yeah, sorry I didn't offer if you wanted to play.
No, it's really okay. I don't do well with mouse and keyboard. And people were saying, well, you should use the Steam controller. That is also the stuff of outtakes.
Ah. I tried to look at the monitor, it said NVIDIA VGA, and then it crashed. Whoops. Yeah, you can't really do anything. You used to be able to, like, access the desktop here, but...
Lip says, we live for outtakes. Go on and play, Elena.
It's giving me a spotty connection warning. And
ooh, really?
Yeah, it's slowing down. Why can't I go into my options? There we go.
It's looking much better, though.
It is running slow, though. Oh, boy.
So, Thomas Evans, if you're having trouble with the front pins, I would just look up the manual for your motherboard, and that should have a diagram that shows you what pins go where. And then if you're looking for the difference between the live one and the ground, usually there's a on the back of, so one side has the label for, like, say, power button, the other side will have usually a little triangle. The one with the triangle is the active one, and the other one is the ground.
Why is it not giving me... It says the NAT is moderate, so that helps at least.
Yeah, this is the thing I ran into when I was working at OXM.
There we go, okay.
Trying to troubleshoot the office network was always a pain.
Yeah, and this thing's... Oh, man, I don't know. I can't tell if it's our connection or if it's in the game, but, man... I mean, we're losing audio. It is not wanting to do anything for me. There we go, okay. Oh, look at that display adapter, NVIDIA Tesla T10.
goodness.
Hmm?
There we go. Full screen. Full screen. Yeah, I mean, I get problems like this at home when it's loading the stupid shaders in the background, but not this bad, this is bad. All right. So refresh rate, oh, the render resolution is not even 100%. Why is that? Ah, man, this is rough.
Peter Jansen, I am always hungry. It's just a matter of how hungry I am.
Oh, the aspect ratio did a default of 19 by 10. That's weird. Oh my god, this is painful.
What is happening? I've been paying attention to chat.
I don't know, it's just like...
Are you having trouble getting it to just...
I mean, you hear the audio just dropping out, it's just...
What is going on?
That render resolution jumped up, what the hell?
Wait, why is it set to... almost 4K.
Yeah. I mean, I tried to set it to 100 as close as I could. I'm just trying to change the aspect ratio right now. It's just like...
Oh, why is it set to 193?
Not taking any of my inputs.
Do you like this? I wasn't paying attention at all. I just come right in and tell you what you should be doing.
Oh, yeah, no, don't worry. I get it. oh, and we crashed. Oh, that's weird. It said that there was an up... Oh, and GeForce Now crashed.
Dun, dun, dun.
Wow.
Oh, that was the highest spike I've seen so far on the CPU in this. Went up to like 50.
Huh. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, you know, I gotta say, for a $50 component, not bad.
Yeah.
It's the little part that could.
All right, let's try this again. Let's try this again. Try changing server. Good point. Well, too late, it's already launching it. Quit. Right now it's on West 2. Let's try West. I'll keep it on auto. Analyzing network. Oh, probably because I tried to change the
Kyle Dragonborn, you haven't actually missed the whole stream. You're just, we've been doing this part for, gosh.
3 hours now?
Almost an hour. Maybe an hour
oh,
and a half.
Oh, this part?
Yeah, this part.
Yeah.
If we can get the Call of Duty working, I would say that we can try to pop in that 570 and do a quick benchmark, and that'll close us out. But otherwise, I might have to save that for whatever write-up I do about this build.
I tested, but it didn't tell me anything.
Nagake, where's your pizza at?
Excuse
it's taking
me.
A long time.
No, yes. I know, right?
Yes, it is.
Well,
I'm very hungry.
It's still technically within the window.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, nope, I just got a notification. It's out for delivery.
Yay!
Oh, yeah, and the estimated delivery has been pushed back. So.
No!
There's the window.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
They're not getting 5 stars from me. I mean, I just won't actually rate them, but they would not get 5 stars from me.
Oh, weird, my Blizzard account has been locked.
Oh, what happened?
Maybe GeForce Now is... keeps messing with it. I wonder if that's from this.
So I don't speak any French, but I think...
Parlez-vous anglais?
Pap Robert. Says, to be honest, it'd be smart to set virtual super resolution as high as you can to have the best clarity as the source image. Stefan says, all this pizza talk is making me hungry. As it should. As it should.
Yeah, I wonder if I just got locked out of my Blizzard account. Weird.
Oh, did you really?
I don't know.
Well, is there another game you want to try, or should we try the RX 570 next?
I started downloading Doom to see how long it would take.
Oh no, 60 gigs on this network is not going to go very quickly.
All right, well, let me kill whatever GeForce Now is doing. Somebody said I could try Doom, not local Doom.
Joseph wants to know, is it possible the lag is because of server flooding on the NVIDIA side due to the new free 3-month promotion? I mean, it's possible, but
it could be, yeah.
I wouldn't be able to tell you one way or the other definitively.
Yeah.
Glenn James says, Blizzard locking, typical, lol. Mm. Dennis Iberian is saying, if Call of Duty is no luck with that, try Doom.
Yeah.
In GeForce Now. Oh, VC Jester with the super chat. Thank you, $5. Appreciate that, sir. See, you should have trusted the 1,000 emails you got saying your Blizzard account was hacked. Pap Robert says, or Pap Robea says, RIP account.
I mean, whatever.
Actually have two people in chat right now having a conversation in French, which I think is kind of awesome. If anyone wants to practice German with me, that'd be great. Keep it simple, though. Like, ich muss zur Toilette or something like that. Not that I want to know the details. Oh wait, there's three people speaking in French, I think.
Wo ist die Toilette?
Wo ist die Toilette?
Okay.
Big Mama in house says, who wants shawarma? Pretty much take anything delicious right now. Ooh, pizza rolls sound good too, Macy Wallace. I see you, E30 Birdie. I see you.
Oh, yeah, I'm even getting sluggish in here.
Ooh.
Oh boy.
What is happening?
Yeah, I can't tell if it's on our side.
It would be interesting to try this with a different build that has more powerful hardware to see if it really is anything that's being... I mean, I don't think it should, though, because, I mean, if we saw the utilization.
Yeah. Any map? Anybody have a map you'd like me to do? I'm taking calls for maps. I did stop downloading Doom.
Ziv went grocery shopping partway through this and got some chicken nuggets. Wait, Ziv, did you get McDonald's chicken nuggets? Did you represent?
Necropolis? Necropolis is kind of dark. I want to try to something a little lighter. Foundry's good, I mean, it's classic. Yeah, I'll just do Foundry. Oh wow, okay, this is a lot quicker.
Dennis Iberian said, near the middle of the game.
Okay, wait, this is in Steam. So, Brad, how do I bring over the hardware?
Oh.
I think there's a way for me to show settings.
Was it Shift? Control O, or was that for Radeon? I'm losing track of the keyboard shortcuts everyone's been giving us.
Okay, well, it is showing locked 60. Well, let me check the settings in here. I feel a little bit of latency with this mouse. 1080p, field of view.
Dennis Siberian wants me to get on the keyboard and mouse, and I won't do it.
Vulcan.
I won't do it publicly.
All right, everything's set to. Oh, look, show performance metrics.
Gal Dragonboard is making a plea to Brad to help your people.
Also, here's some metrics in the game.
Alt F4 would just close the window. Thanks for the troll.
Yeah, well, I know that one. So it looks like the CPU utilization. Oh, so there's showing the frame. Frame max 32, min average for the CPU. The GPU, no, that can't be right. It says frames, max frames like 10 frames a second. On a, running on a T10, whoop. But it actually doesn't feel bad. Oh, wow. Ah, crap. I forgot how to.
Did you
playing
try,
on the Steam controller.
Did you
crap.
Try Brad's suggestion of Alt plus Z? Did, is that what this is?
No, this is the overlay in Alt plus Z. Oh, no, Alt Z is GeForce.
Yeah, that's experience. What Brad was suggesting.
Yeah, no Alt Z in this. Crap, I forgot all my buttons in this guy. How do I melee kill?
This is actually a pretty good point. Dennis Iberian just pointed out, like, we are playing Doom 2016 on an Athlon part right now.
Yeah.
Pretty good.
At everything set to max on 1080p.
We had a random commenter stop by and said, well, why would you build something, you know, using 14 nanometer, spend $500 and get a current build? Like, well, you know, everyone has different price, yeah. Different budgets.
I mean, for $300, this is a good build for your kid. Even though Gordon thinks your kid's going to grow out of it, you know, hey, $300, get him started. It's either that or a Switch. A Switch is $300. What the hell is the melee button? Why can't I remember my goddamn buttons on this? Whoop, that's not the melee button. Somebody help me. What's the melee button? It's F. That's what it is. So it's weird that these performance metrics.
Oh, Elvis, not. That's not very nice. Adam's just as good as Hayden in terms of companionship.
Companionship?
Yeah, they're basically implying that you shouldn't be playing these games. I should have Hayden do it instead.
Oh, Hayden do it, yeah. He is the best PC gamer ever.
Oh, Brad's out. Bye, Brad. Thanks
See
for
Brad.
Hanging out with us.
Oh, God, I haven't played this in a while. Actually, the shotgun's always my favorite. All right, where are we going? Boom. Red, blue. I don't have any of these. Where do I get the key card? Crap, I keep hitting R to reload, and that is not reload. Also, shift slows you down, it doesn't speed you up. This game's backwards sometimes.
I gotta tell you, sometimes switching between games, I get my controls confused because it's not always standardized.
Well, it's especially weird because I've been playing on the Steam controller. Like, I'm starting to. There we go. Starting to get used to it. Oh, crap. Right in my face.
So, Lazar Marius wants to know, how is the input lag?
Yeah, it actually doesn't feel too bad at all. Like, I mean, once again, as everyone's pointing out, I'm not the best PC gamer around, but it doesn't feel bad. I'm not gonna complain. For me, I'm seeing more. What's bugging me more is like the artifacting. I can tell when the resolution drops, especially during like fast movement. That's bugging me a little bit more. The input latency isn't. But I'm more of a visual guy anyway. We've already established that.
Dennis Siberian wants to know if you can switch the Steam controller.
Sure. I would love to. So it's got to install it on the...
Will this take a while, though?
No. You should download the driver.
Do you
locally.
Need this to be anything faster than a 2.0?
No.
Okay. Every time. Think you have it the wrong way? Turn around? Nope. It was the first way. Mm. Every time.
There we go. All right. So the device is ready. Let's see if it'll read it. Oh, yeah. Oh, boy. Ooh. We lost resolution somehow. And, oh, you know what? It's not picking up my profile. Yeah, because I can't enable big picture mode.
You might have to.
There it is. Controller settings. Why is it? Huh. Yeah, it's not. Oh no, it is. There it is. Identify. Yep.
Boop-a-doop.
Okay.
Cal Dragonborn, we used an ASRock A320M-HDV board. I actually used an older version. We bought this at the end of 2017. I think the version that I have linked is the revision 4, or at least says R4.0. That's what I assume it means.
So this is weird. It's not pulling in the community. Oh, no, there it is. It just took a second. But I have my own. Whoop. What? Wrong button. Ah!
Brent Meiser Wannabe 3000X says, GeForce Now is the first time I've played when the system GPU had more RAM than my CPU has access to.
All right, how do I switch out of big picture?
Zach Puderball thinks that there will be considerable input lag with the Steam controller if you play it wireless, but plugging it in would mitigate that. Pat Robert, we did try actually. We wanted to do Crysis, but neither Adam or I have it in our Steam libraries.
Yeah,
he has Crysis 2, but not Crysis the first one. So we'll probably try that later offline when we can go ahead and purchase it and install it and all that just to see how it does.
Oof, and not only are we getting real bad.
What happened to the resolution?
I don't know, it's getting real bad.
I mean, look at these pixel blocks. Holy crap. Yeah.
For me, yeah, it's like, it's not recognizing the Steam controller the way it needs to. Weird. Oh. Oh yeah, this resolution's, oh boy. Oh boy.
It's not good.
Okay.
Okie dokie.
Yeah. This is a thing. Oh, got a little better. Oh wait, did it drop something for me? No, I think I was just clearing. Yeah, oh boy, this is, I mean, it's giving me the network problems, or the network errors, which makes sense. I mean, interesting enough, even though it's dropping the resolution down to butt, that is
to
a technical
butt,
term.
That's a technical word for it.
The latency on the controller inputs is actually not too bad.
Stefan, we were thinking of doing Crysis locally. We weren't talking about doing it through GeForce Now.
Man, but yeah, we're, I can't play
this. Dejar says, now it looks like real Doom.
Yeah, pretty much. Oh crap. Yep. All right. So.
Drayden says 20. Sorry. Drayden says 640 by 480 as God intended.
Yeah, pretty much. You know, I wonder if it was because I was messing around with this. Oh, it make me interesting. Wait, what was the other game people said?
Oh gosh, I think I lost it.
There's one other game.
hit us up with your game request again. We're hanging in there until our pizza comes.
Yeah.
Wait, what was Battlefield. Yeah, Battlefield's not on here. Overwatch. Well, I do have League.
Somebody said Dirt.
Quake Champions. Alright, alright, alright. I'm not good at it. Definitely not good at it. Oops. I think I have to log into that too.
Oh, so many logins today. We have a question about the CPU. Kyle Dragonborn, do you mean like the GPU component of the APU? Because the CPU doesn't have any boost to it. It's just a base clock as far as I know.
Oh, I need to play. Doo-doo.
I don't know if the graphics side actually has a boost either. I think it's just 1100 megahertz. Oh. Dennis Iberian says, Elena should play some Assassin's Creed. Yes, I would totally do that, but I don't think that really matters for what we're doing here. Also, if someone gave me an actual Xbox controller, I would try playing. I thought I would be very good, but still.
Oh, did somebody say anything about how we pull up the information on Steam?
Oh, I mean, they've said it multiple times, but I lost it in the chat.
And we're still getting this spotty connection.
I don't know what's going on with our connection.
Yeah, this is bad. Oh, also we're at 100. Oh, you know what? Whoops. You know what? I think when I switched over to Big Picture, yep, it started downloading Doom in the background.
Oh, that's why. Oh,
okay.
Can you just exit out? Like, just get rid of it. Just goodbye.
Whoops, library. Okay. I was wondering, I was like, man, when I switched over to Big Picture, it was not happy. Okay, all right, that's better.
Yeah, as Ziv mentions, you can overclock the 3000G, but I don't think you would want to do it on this board. I mean, A320 isn't really suited for that. But yes, you can actually overclock this because it's an unlocked part, which is kind of nice. You get a little extra performance out of a $50 CPU. I think that's really neat.
So for those wondering, when it brought up the that I had to install the game, I'm not installing it locally. I'm installing it on the cloud side, which is why it loaded so quick. Let's see if I can do Quake Champions on a...
Small percentage of people may experience seizures.
I do like the sound that makes it's the haptics on the circle.
Yeah, I can hear the vibration on that.
And it's actually set to medium, I think.
How loud is it when it's actually set?
It can get pretty loud.
As loud as my fitness tracker?
Maybe. Choose region.
I want my pizza so bad. Oh, we forgot to tell Gordon we were testing. We don't wait till when we're starting.
You just knock on the wall.
Go, Gordon.
God, I haven't played this since it first came out. Oh, I can only do. Oh, I can only do practice. T
Team Deathmatch.
Well, it's not. You're going to have to explain what a leisure seizure is.
I'm also going to have to explain why I'm so bad at this game. Why is the resolution scale immediately bumped down to 66%? That's weird.
Yeah, for everyone in the chat, yes, that's correct. When I said you can't overclock on A320, I meant just the CPU. But yes, you can load XMP profiles from the RAM.
Here we go. Okay. Oh, I'm getting a call.
Is it the pizza?
Hello? Hello? On the sixth floor? All right, cool. We'll come meet you in a second.
I'll go get it.
Thanks, bye.
I'm getting pizza.
Here,
I'll
let me meet you. There's a little switch. Yep.
She won't be doing
it. Oh, you're not even linked up. Why? What?
That's weird.
Yep.
Can't
hear me? No, I guess not. Weird. Did nobody tell me her mic dropped? No link. What happened? What happened? Did the battery die? Oh yeah. Wow, okay. Oh yeah, battery died on this. Give me a second. There we go. All right. Oh, I'm back right in time. Perfect. Church of Azoth. All right, watch me suck real bad at this. Let me mute. Ah. Excuse me. Ooh-wee. I am getting some. Oh, this is running bad.
I have food.
Yay, food. So yeah, the battery was out.
Oh, the battery was out.
Yeah, I replaced it. I guess nobody noticed. They couldn't. I mean, they could probably pick you up on my mic enough.
I guess.
There you go. I mean, they still should have been able to pick you up.
Oh, mic. Gosh. All right, let's try this again.
Just practice.
Oh, great.
Practice while people see me suck at this game.
I did not say that yet, but all right. Oh, I had no idea that you can hear me. Sorry, I was in a different window. Actually, you know, Leanne, like in the BIOS, it actually says XMP. I'm just going by what Azrock decided to name it. Are we all muted?
No.
Why? That's...
People are saying we can't.
Yeah.
Oh.
Your battery died too. That's what happened.
Oh, you know what?
Oh gosh. All right. Sorry, everybody.
Oh, well, you're good. People should be able to hear you.
Only silence. Everything is dead.
Is everything dead?
No, I'm just scrolling up to try to see what people were saying.
Yeah, this thing's dead.
Whew.
And I don't have the back.
All right.
All right.
All right. Sorry, everybody. Let me go through that again.
No, you know, yeah, I'm going to quit this. I'm tired of losing. Oh boy.
Okay, everything's better now. Okay, this person, I'm sorry, you need to go on a timeout.
Oh wait, now I'm back?
Didn't you?
I don't know.
did yours go out in sympathy with mine?
I have no idea. I don't know. maybe it's because I suck at the game. It was giving problems.
Okay. Okay, so everyone can hear me now, right? Before I go through this whole spiel again, I don't want to do it three times.
We'll go through it and then we're done.
Yeah, we got pizza.
How do I...
Well, everyone's not commenting to tell me they can hear me. What? Oh, so apparently you cut out when I plugged mine back in. That's super weird. Patrick VDV, we are using the integrated graphics on the Athlon 3000G right now. Okay, thanks everybody. Okay, so for the person who asked what our parts list was, this is our Athlon 3000G build. Obviously we're using the Athlon 3000G. For the CPU, paired with it is an ASRock A320M HDV board. The one we have in here is probably one of the first iterations of it because I had to update the BIOS quite a bit for this build. I'm guessing if you buy it now, you don't have to worry quite so much about that. But because I have an older one, I'm not sure if you buy this exact model, if you would need a boot kit in order to actually use the 3000G with it. So it might be worth actually messaging ASRock, Gigabyte, whoever you choose to see if that's the case. Memory that we have in here right now is actually two DIMMs of Corsair 2800 megahertz RAM. DDR4, obviously. This is because I didn't have any 3000 on hand that with two DIMMs, and I wanted a dual channel configuration for this build, given that we're running graphics off the APU. But in the parts list I have in the description, I just, you know, pulled in Patriot, the Viper 4 Blackout. It's a two DIMMs at 4 gigabytes each. It's like $40, so just pretty much any basic RAM kit will work for this. Storage is Intel 1660p NVMe drive. This is the 512 capacity. It's a little more expensive, obviously, than if you went with a 1 terabyte hard disk drive, but I figure this build is still under $300. If you needed to cut costs more, you could shave it there, but I figured given that it would load much faster than a hard disk drive, it's worth the investment. Case is Thermaltake Versa H15. We actually had a choice between this and the H22 behind the boxes there that you can't see. We made it community choice and everyone chose the H15. And then power supply, what I have in here right now is an EVGA 430 watt power supply. It's just very basic 80 plus, not even 80 plus bronze, but just 80 plus. What I recommend in the parts list is slightly better. It's a 450 watt 80 plus bronze power supply. It was on sale yesterday, so I think it was about like $35 after mail-in rebate. If you really don't even need this much wattage for only the $300 version of this build, but if you decide to do a discrete GPU like that RX 570 at the end of the table there, then you do want, you know, a little bit more room for that to accommodate that.
So this would, the 450 would accommodate that RX 570 according to all the calculators I did a, you know, spot check on. 430 is probably right around that limit, so I don't know if I'll drop in the 570 anyway right now since Adam and I are very hungry. Mm-hmm. That's it, it's a really simple build, that was it.
You know, and maybe, what's today, is today Wednesday?
Yep. Today is Wednesday. I'm gonna eat. I'm sorry. I'm just gonna have.
All right. Let's peace out. Let's peace out. Say bye to everybody.
What do you mean? I can eat while you play games. I don't care.
No, I'm. And my mic pack did die. So.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. Anyway.
All right. We're gonna
let's
end
get
this
out of here.
Really abruptly. If you're curious about how Crysis runs on this locally, because we did want to try, you know, the whole like, does it run Crysis thing. We'll do that offline. We're also going to try, or I'm going to try the RX 570 just to see how that works. Since this is such a basic CPU and a basic motherboard, I don't really know if I have enough. I mean, I don't have enough PCIe lanes to run this in x16 mode. So I'm kind of wondering if this is going to step down to x8 or x4. So we'll see how that affects performance. But yeah, look for the write-up on PCWorld.com. Thank you for tuning in and hanging out with us for like, what, 3 hours? Three and a half hours?
3.5 hours.
For whoever was saying that if we could do it under 4 hours, we did it.
Oh no, the build went quick. Oh,
the build
great.
Happened super fast,
yeah.
But the whole stream is still under 4 hours.
Yeah.
And now we're gonna eat pizza, and
pizza
I'm
time.
Really excited by this.
Pizza time. Thank you, everybody.
Yep.
Thank you, Elena.
Stay tuned,
thank
we're gonna have more live builds this year, so
yeah.
You can hang out with us then.
We'll see you later.
Bye.